What's going on, guys? Thanks for tuning in. Welcome, welcome. Hey, Deez, what's up happening? What's going on with you? Can't even speak here. And Lechem, what's going on? JBS? Oh, indeed, yes. TFC will be going to the finals. Yeah, Girlfriend Jedi was actually at that game you were talking about before. And yeah, the trams. Yeah, you saw that episode too. It definitely made its way past your building, but... And hopefully Duckers will be here. I know he watches this stuff offline, so you can say hi to him too. Okay, let me get some tunes set up. I've got one more thing I just need to post right here. Just running a little bit behind, as usual. And what am I looking for? Yes. Alright, welcome, friends. Let's do some in-game music, because I love the classical music from this, just to kind of start us off. And just kind of going back to last week's stream, like, so we didn't save our progress, because we really only did, like a fraction of building. And all we did was just destroy the city and run into, like, tremendous amounts of issues with, like, traffic and a whole bunch of other stuff. So, yeah, let's refocus, you know. Let's have a new strategy when it comes to the natural disasters thing here. Mr. Duck, you are here! Yes, my heart, it grows 2 sizes per minute.
Meow.
Oh, gosh. Oh boy, and CB, what's going on, man? I forgot to say hi to you. Thanks for tuning in. Welcome, welcome. Mod on this account? Used to be a mod, CB Elites? Oh, when was that? Oh. Here, send me a whisper. We'll chat for a little bit over here. Or we'll chat afterwards. But yeah, I can probably do that, no problem, man. okay, let's focus on the stream for a second here. Okay, so yeah, let's just hop in. Let's have some fun with this. I'm just noticing that these roads here are pretty steep. I'm actually going to start by changing that. And let's kind of do a bit of zoning in this part here. And let's start working in slowly our natural disasters. But I want to make sure that we're actually using them. So I want to... There we go. I'm going to turn the frequency up a little bit, just so we have some challenge here. Let's have a whisper. Yeah, you guys can always send me whispers, you know? Yeah, the new radio stations are pretty darn cool. And I got some more. And they'll be progressively releasing some new ones from what I understand. Okay, so yeah, I'm just going to redo this, but have it kind of maybe go on a bit more of an angle. And then we can do like an emergency shelter kind of here in the cliffside. Oops. I've been recording all morning, so I have, like, no voice right now, which is the worst. Okay, let's try... Yeah, that's better, right? Man, Nightbot... Where would we be without Nightbot, though, guys? Nightbot is, like, our friend. That's way too steep, especially for a tram. What we could do is maybe have part of this kind of maybe come up as a bridge. And maybe this tunnel, actually. Yeah, that's kind of neat. Let's go tunnel for a fraction and then kind of maybe come up. Yeah, that's kind of cool. I just don't want it to be so steep. So maybe this like winding effect will be kind of neat. But this is just a one-way track so far. Yeah, well, I have the natural disasters, like the random events, whatever, they're turned on. So we'll see some, and we'll probably just test out a few, but I want to just make sure we get to set up for it first. And I'm kind of stubborn, so I just want to finish just doing this first. Okay, where are we going to connect to? We're going to need a road that has tram tracks. Can always... change one of these over and run a tram up along here. Let's try that. This is a cool idea. Hey, Ishy Tishy, what's going on? Okay. Oh, and CB, I remember your whatchamacallit? Your Twitch logo. Or like your thumbnail thing. Okay, so this is our trams coming through. Connect over to here. I do wanna do another tram line this episode. That's kinda cool. It just goes in and around down through here. Okay, yeah. Hey Nelsie, what's going on? Welcome. Okay, so trams are gonna have to converge on that road there. I'm gonna slightly upgrade part of this just for a bit more traffic flow. I guess we're stuck at that intersection there, which is really no problem. We'll just do that. And then we'll go out. I don't know if we can get the same kind of angle, but I'm gonna give it a go. That could look kind of neat. It's gonna be a little bit tricky though to do. Oh, geez. I later tonight, I'm actually seeing Girlfriend Jedi, so no second stream today. But I can do, I'll do a Planet Coaster stream midweek. But I have that series started. So you can always watch a little bit of offline content. So the downside to what we're doing right here is we don't get any zoning done. So what we could do is maybe bring a little bit of this out. Bit of a cliffside kind of feeling, but. Let's try that. Yeah, Kobe, I recognize you just based on the thumbnail. I'm like kind of weird like that. Names I usually forget, but I remember what people's what their thumbnail is or whatever for either Twitch or. So don't take that the wrong way that I forgot about you. Okay, there we go. So this way now we can have both sides of the street connect, and. Just for, I don't think we'll ever use it, but I'm gonna have just maybe that. And I guess like people who live here could use that as a turnaround point, but I don't think a tram would turn around there. But I imagine in real life you might have like a spot in case there's like a road accident and you have to, you know, move a tram in a different direction type thing. Okay, how are we gonna enter through here? I guess what we could do is bridge and then come in. Gosh, this is so complicated. We could come in from like here if we can get in. Yeah, I guess so. Yeah, I thought I had that before, having like really steep, kind of like San Francisco style avenues, but it looked a little bit too much. And I'm kind of feeling these like windy curves these days. Yeah, but anyways, for those of you who are just hopping in, we are going to be doing some natural disaster stuff this stream. I just want to get the city. I'm kind of stubborn. I want to fix this little spot right here, and then we can put in some disaster shelters and stuff, and then get ready for that. And then we can test some disasters out. I don't necessarily want to level the city like we did last week, but I do have the random disasters turned on, so there's a chance that something could happen, and. You know, we're on a live stream, right? So I can't escape from it. We're gonna have to deal with it type thing. So we'll see how it goes. Slightly downhill here. Please just line up. Yay! Okay, let's get that going. I hope that's not too chaotic for traffic. It's a lot of action, but that's kind of the same way we had the roundabout before. So I guess we're kind of fine. Hey, Nikki, what's going on? Thanks for tuning in. Okay, that looks kind of neat. Let's maybe get some function out of it too. Okay, so let's put the game on now that this is reconnected and we can get some vehicles going through here. And this way we have a chance at some disasters hitting. So let's start putting some of those things down. I'm gonna start with our fire watchtowers. Actually, no, let's go through and just kind of run them down like this. So I'm gonna make our radio towers and all that stuff first, and then we'll set up the early warning system. I love these buildings so much. And so your radio towers are gonna notify the Sims if you have an early warning system that there's an approaching disaster. And these things only work if you got a source of power for them. Oh, Nosley, no problem at all, man. That's totally why I do the things. You're very welcome to, we're all building the cities together, right? I hope you guys get inspiration. That's kind of why I do these things, right? Anyway, so these giant radio towers, they need electricity to work. You don't have to run a road connection out to them. But what I sometimes do, just for an aesthetic kind of look, is I'll just draw, like a dirt road or something kind of going towards it. And, darn it. Okay, well, you know, everything's always easier in my mind. There we go. So not that anyone would really use that, because there's no reason to go there, but just visually it looks like it's now a bit more real. And you can always put some, like, trees and stuff, right? There. Lovely. Okay. Radio towers, where are you? Right. And so these have a coverage radius. Things like hillsides and stuff are affected by that too. So you can kind of see on the far side of the hill, not really the best. So you want to make sure your whole city is covered. And if you don't have a good radio coverage, when you kind of sound the alarm, not everyone's going to get the message to head to an emergency shelter, which is kind of bad. And I think we just need power lines for this. Cheat and put that in place right there. I like doing that. That's kind of nice. I think that warped the roundabout. Oh, it may have. No, actually, you know what? It was warped before. Yeah, I kind of remember this one. It's like because of the terrain and stuff, and we had like a lot of weird streets connecting to it. That's such a strange little crooked bend, though. I don't know. It's not really how I wanted it to turn out, but better than nothing. Okay, so our city now has radio coverage. Arguably, we could probably use another tower over here. Drop that in someone's backyard, no problem. Okay, so let's put in some of our early warning systems now. This is an earthquake sensor. Let's put a few of these throughout town. And these have fairly decent coverage. Slot one maybe over here. How much did you spend on a PC? What do you, like, it's kind of tough. Like, these days, you can get away with, like, $800 is kind of a price point for a pretty decent PC. But I kind of think, like, I'm in the camp where I feel like you should wait the extra two, three, you know, weeks, months, whatever it is, just to get better parts. So for, like, me, my computer's a little bit more on the higher end, is for, by that logic. But you don't really have to break the bank anymore, because like a very decent video card you can get for like $150. You can get really good motherboard CPU combos, also for like under $200. RAM is like dirt cheap these days. You get like 16 gigs for like $150 usually or less, for like decent RAM. Storage is cheap, like a 500 gig hard drive, terabyte hard drive, not really hard to come by, get a couple of those. Solid states are even getting cheaper these days too. Cases, a dime a dozen. You don't need anything too fancy there, you know? $100 or less for a case. What's really getting expensive these days are, like, keyboards and, like, you know, headphones and, like, those kind of things, right? Like, your headsets. Well, I mean, yeah, I guess that's still a lot of money, but it's, like, obviously it's more money than a console. It's just, you know, again, going with, like, my first thought process. If you, like, spend $600 or $700 and you end up with like a cool PC, but then you're just like, oh man, I wish I had this much better, you know, graphics card, I wish I had that little bit extra RAM, or so you don't want to like live in the world of regret. That's kind of what I'm saying. Alright, so tsunami warnings. Let's put a couple of those boys in the waterways. And these will just let us or just warn us of like a drastic change in water height. So like, you know, a tsunami or something is heading our way. All right, Deez, I'll see you in a bit, man. Oh, Salty, yeah, sorry sometimes Nightbot will get you. But yeah, build a PC. And there's also some subreddits for it, too. And guys, if you want to post a link, we have a few moderators here. Just ask for permission. Usually it's no problem. If you post something that you definitely know you shouldn't, you'll get a swift ban. But I trust you guys, you know? Okay, so I'm going to temporarily put these down. They're not going to be in the final location. I just want to get them in. This is a Doppler radar. And this one right here is just kind of advanced warning for meteors. But I want this to be on the top of a hillside eventually. And I want this to be maybe where, like, we'll see how the airport kind of comes in. But these things you would find at airports anyhow, so. Very busy train station here. This will be a cool little transport hub when it's all kind of said and done. Still lots to do with it, though. Okay, so a few of our early warning things are in place. I think actually that's all of them. Yeah, that is all of them. Sweet. Let's start putting in some of our emergency shelters now. And I made the mistake of not setting a route alongside with them last time. So you can see you have like your evacuation route. And I think that's for the buses. So let's just go. Oh, I guess there's tram stops there. Let's make our way down there to pick up people, and then just head back up to the shelter. But people, I believe, will still drive over on their own if you just hit the, you know, the option to send them on in. Oh, Ishii, you know who asks about you often is our good friend Beef. I don't know if you guys are still chatting or not, but you have to come back for a rest stream because we're in a brand new map seed. We can make another one of those like walls that has everyone's name and everything on it. Oh gosh, pipes. Okay, I'm gonna forget about that. All right, so one shelter in. Let's put a few more. You can see they've got a. Kind of like a radius. And your routing kind of helps with that too. And you've got smaller ones that people can kind of walk into. Oh, we didn't put one of these things down, the disaster response unit. You really only need like one or two of these in your city. But these guys here are going to be like a disaster management team essentially. They'll send out helicopters, kind of clear the roads, work with your emergency services to kind of get things picked up and whatnot. And as a bonus, it's a really cool looking building. So since we're going to be launching helicopters and stuff off it, I imagine that would probably be around here. And the end goal for the top of this little spot is we want to buy the next tile over, expand this out, make the highway in kind of like a tunnel thing, and then we want to have an airport at the top of this hill. So this is just kind of like placeholder for the moment, but this is going to be pretty cool right there. The next rest stream, I'm probably going to be having one midweek. I won't be doing one tonight. I know sometimes on Sundays we do a double stream, but a little bit preoccupied this evening. But yeah, one day for sure this week we'll do it. I'm actually a little bit behind in Rust in general. Haven't played in the last few days. Okay, so let's start putting a few more of these in, and then we can drop down the helicopter depots for like the fire and everyone. Nice. I guess we can just kind of have these go around the areas that they're kind of near. But I'm kind of fine putting down, say, a few of the shelters versus having to do this many bus routes. So I don't want to make these too long. I feel like that's probably inefficient. There, a little bit of coverage right there. That's not so bad. Don't trust the Canadians. Oh, no, no, no. Oh, and I'm currently playing without any mods right now. This is just kind of like a vanilla experience. But I do have like a mod list for one when I do play with mods, so you guys can still access that. The goal for this stream, I guess, is just to get the city ready for some disasters. We had tried that last week But it was still, like, I was still pretty new to, like, we got the DLC a little bit early, and I just jumped right into streaming it before really figuring it all out. So we didn't do the best job. We kind of financially went broke, and then we just kind of blew up the city just in kind of instead. So I wouldn't say last week was very productive. So I want to, yeah, just get the city ready for emergency services and disasters and, like, that kind of stuff. And then we can test a few of them out in a more, like, controlled environment. I am running, like, I have them on random right now, so there's a chance we could just have, like, any old disaster hit us. So there's that element of surprise and danger. And also, you know, the goal is just to have some fun. We're kind of a weird, we're a weird group of, you know? We have a fun little community here. Bunch of internet weirdos, I like it, though. You guys are all right. Okay, neat. You're binging on my channel last night? Oh, well, I'm glad you were. Yeah, I just crossed 21,000, moving pretty quickly. Cause I only just crossed 20,000 too, so. But I've been, you know, talking to other content creators and stuff. And it's in terms of like when you hit 10,000, you really notice a pretty big difference. And this is kind of productive since we have the other one there. So I'm not going to draw a route on that. But yeah, when you hit 10,000 subscribers on YouTube, you kind of notice a really big, just general push forward in terms of momentum. And then it's like that, but like, you know, bigger when you hit 20,000. But just in general, like the first 1,000, that's the hardest thing to do on YouTube. And after that, it's kind of, it becomes easier, I guess. Okay. Also, this caught my attention last stream. We have to fix this because there's just too much traffic happening. And it's just a matter of just the trams, most likely. I think we could maybe have a tram. I don't know. Because now that I stare at it, traffic's fine, right? Ah, darn it. Alright, well, whatever. I don't want to get bogged down by that. Let's go back to our emergency stuff here. So just, yeah, a few more shelters. Probably put one near the stadium, that would make sense. Here's another intersection that's gonna need some love and attention. Because last stream too, when we started dropping some of the disasters down and everyone had to like drive to an emergency shelter, like our roads just got so flooded with traffic. So I don't think we're doing the best job in terms of planning, unfortunately. So yeah, we'll kind of examine some intersections, see if we can make some improvements. The other thing I was thinking is maybe we could run like a little short metro line. Just kind of have like one go just maybe like along here and one just kind of go through there to our transport hub. Just to get some people off the roads. Kind of tackle traffic in a different sense. Okay, well, not much coverage over here. And then these things, they have a cost associated with them too, so I don't want to go bonkers and put like a gazillion of these down. I'll draw a few routes over here, and this is just for the bus route and everything that goes around and picks up people. So I think maybe just one down here, and then a couple over here, and then we'll drop down a disaster and just kind of see what happens. And I'll kind of show you what I mean about traffic. We'll see what goes on there. I'm not going to drop like a bazillion disasters, but maybe we'll just start a forest fire or something, just kind of see what's going on. Oh, and we still need, what am I saying, the helicopter depots. Okay, I don't want to get too far ahead of myself then. Yeah, the i5-6600 is such a good processor. Either that one, or the i7-4790K. Or like really anything that ends with a K, because then you can overclock it. And, you know, even like a GTX like 770, I know it's a little bit of an older one, one that has like a 6 gig or like even 4 gig option, like, that has a lot of power still these days, and those things are like $150 or something, or less even, I believe. Or the GTX 1050. You can get one of those, the TI ones. So it's a little bit faster. Those things are pretty cool, and they're well priced too. I think they're only like $225 or something. Brand new, probably less even. Oh my goodness, Billy, you're a maniac! Doing a severity 10 meteor in the middle of town? No, we're not. We did all that last stream, and it was like, my heart, it broke into a million pieces watching the poor city fall apart. Like, I'll do a few, but like, I don't want to, like, it's hard to come back from that stuff, basically. But I have random disasters turned on, so there's theoretically a chance of that happening. And if it does, like, I'm up for the challenge of trying to deal with it. It's just like, I can't. It's like one of those things, you can't hurt yourself. I can't consciously destroy the city. Like, it would just break my heart too much. Alright, so maybe do a couple of little walking ones since it's a little bit more compact over here. That's a nice little spot for it. There. Okay. So essentially our entire city now has radio coverage, so if we were to sound the alarm or a disaster were to kind of make its way in, people would get a warning for it. And we now have all of our advanced warning systems set up. So we've got earthquake sensors, we've got a meteor detector, we've got Doppler radar, and my goodness gracious me, we need a highway connection over here. Yeah, see, all of this stuff was, I remember from last stream now, it's all kind of coming back to me. Yeah, natural disasters, it definitely, the new mechanics, they add, like, especially the fire and everything, it adds a lot more strain on the PC, that's for sure. I've heard that as a number one kind of feedback. Yeah, I feel like with this game, I mean, it is pretty graphics and CPU intensive. Even if you have an older computer, if you have a video card that has like 4 gigs or more, even if it's old, it'll chug pretty well for this. And even if, you know, if you have like an old like i5 or first generation i7, you can still do a pretty good job with this. I went from a first gen i7 to a newer i7, and it was like, oh my goodness, it was like a ray of golden sunshine type thing. I'm just gonna do a little bit of residential zoning just somewhere to get some people in. Maybe in our new little hillside community, and then we can just drop down some disasters here. I just want some, like, what's the point of this area if no one's gonna use it, right? And then I do want to bring in like a tram and stuff through here, like I was saying. Otherwise, yeah, what's the point of us drawing all those tracks in the beginning, right? And I really like the hillsides, and I like to kind of curve just gently with them, just kind of go in the kind of flow that they offer. And I think it just ends up looking really neat for kind of overlapping high density houses, especially the European ones. Where's that gonna go? That's fine like that. Because when you look at it like this way, it's just tiered upwards. It looks just so cool. Even if the first row is like houses, yeah, that's even a better idea. Hey, you know what? We should build a waterfall now that you mention it, guys. Thank you for reminding me. But no, you can do it really easily now. Like, I even tried it off camera. Because you get these things here. You get freshwater outflow pipes. And like, we'll go over these too. These are some new buildings that that come with the Natural Disasters DLC. You also get the radio stations too, which is why my music is a little bit different. Oh, actually, you get the radios as the free DLC, I believe. But we have other stations though, because I'm a fanboy. I bought the other DLC stuff. I also got the what are they called? The high tech buildings. I don't know if you guys saw that little DLC pack as well. I think that was made by a content creator. So like these here, I got some new things we can kind of work with, like, you know, television station. Like, that's cool, right? Very nice. All right, so let's just let that build. That's helping a lot with our demand, which is great. I just want this to kind of become populated again. And we definitely need a new interchange for the highway, otherwise this will be a disaster forever. But let's just put that on hold for 1 second. Actually, we didn't put any firewatch towers in. And I'm so distracted. Oops. In the firewatch towers, it's just like these guys here. They only need electricity. And unfortunately in this game, you don't get a smaller scale set of electrical lines to kind of work with. But I'd like to bring the power lines out regardless, even if they look big. So we'll do that. You don't need to do a road. I'm just doing that for fun type thing. And you can see right here, that's what's going to keep your forest safe. And we were doing some really neat testing, and I'll show you guys that again. And I'll probably put one more over here. In town, fire watchtowers. It just seems a little silly to me, but why not? I believe we could use a regular fire station over here. And so yeah, the fire watchtowers, they're just going to work kind of with your helicopter depots, like I was saying a little bit before. So up here, it's most likely, like I said, going to be just airport-style stuff, so I don't see why we shouldn't have some helicopter depots here. We do need to be close to a body of water. Luckily, we have a river that runs through our entire town, so that's like extraordinarily convenient. So I'm going to put a few of these just kind of spread out. I think a town of this size, just from what I've been testing around, you probably need three or four of these depots, just so you kind of have pretty decent response. It'll be challenging to get a spot over here, though. It's not too steep. Oh, gosh. Well, we can do it over here. Probably not a permanent spot for that. I think I might maybe make like a little isolated quadrant for that, but... Oh yeah, we have a few people tuning in now, it's good. Well, like Sunday, it's kind of like my, my only scheduled stream, so people kind of know to tune in, hopefully, for this day. And we can probably use an incinerator, I think, over here. So much of this stuff is just temporary, and then it, like, just gets put on hold, and I never remember to do that, and then we have, like, a big list of things, and... Actually, it's really cool, too. So fire, just a normal, natural thing in town. With the new natural disaster mechanics, though, fire spreads to the building next to it. So you have to be, like, super on top of things. And what's cool is the fire helicopters will be dispatched, too, to help deal with that. So if it was getting out of control, we'd eventually see them kind of fly in. Anyway, I'm slowly pacing and getting towards dropping a disaster or two so we can test some stuff out. And I'll show you guys some neat stuff with some forest fires and everything. Oh, Delroy, hey, what's up, man? Yeah, I'm having, like, I think way too much fun with the vanilla series. And, like, the new tutorial series, that's really cool and fun to work on, too. Like, so many people, it's, like, just in the last week alone. Like, they watched, like, the other series I did, the one with, like, mods. And they're like, man, I wish this didn't have mods. Thanks, though. And I was like, oh. I think, like, those kind of comments, and they're like, came here for a tutorial? You're using mods? What is this, for new players? And I'm like, yes, I don't know. Like, so... I was like, fine, I'll just do it. I'm happy, it turned out really well. Okay, so in terms of a forest fire, see, our budget's a little bit negative now, so I gotta stop putting all these things down. Alright, so the forest fire, it's not too much of a threat unless you have an area that's really, really, really densely packed with trees. And I'll kind of show you guys the difference. So right now, you can see there's a fair amount of tree coverage over here. So let's just start a forest fire.
The Forest Service has stated that there is a risk of an imminent forest fire in the area.
Actually, we'll do it on three speed.
Residents are advised to avoid forested areas.
Just one single tree. I imagine this probably won't even spread. So most of the time when a forest fire happens, it's like there's really nothing to worry about. Let me actually try that one more time, because that was a little bit silly.
The Forest Service has stated that there is a risk of an imminent forest fire in the area.
Oh, and if you want, you can control the intensity of your disaster. Something else I missed last stream. So there's our helicopter coming in. See, that one burned itself out, so it's like not much of a threat unless your trees are really, really close together. So let's put in a bucket of trees here, like a whole buttload. I'm just gonna click like crazy, so forgive me. Oh, look, Natic, I'm glad to hear that. Honestly, I have a lot of fun making them too. I've been meaning to do a remake, because, you know, so much changes over the course of a year in the game anyway, especially with mods and stuff. And a lot of them have been integrated and stuff. So whenever I watch like my old series, it just feels so dated to me. I just notice so many things. I'm like, oh man, that's such a, like, no, that's been fixed now. Especially the first episode, or not the first episode, the very first one I made. It's like, it's so many people. They're just like, you know, you can switch the direction of the roads, bro. And I'm like, I know. But when the game came out, you couldn't. They're like, you sure? Because I'm sure you can. I'm like, no, I'm like, you can. I'm like, I made this video the day the game came out. I'm like, yes. So, oh my goodness. I'm exaggerating. I think for the most part, I get pretty pleasant comments. Okay, so you can kind of see now we're like super tree overboard. I'm actually going to keep on planting some more. I think we're on a good roll here. Get some more variety. And honestly, yeah, just plain vanilla. I mean, you almost forget how playable the game is. And it's just, it's so smooth. 7.5k, that's a pretty decent size. That's what I'm hoping to get our vanilla city up to. So we can unlock incinerators. This is a fairly decent sized city. I think in real life, a city of this size would have a population way higher than 36,000. This for me would feel like maybe 150k, maybe 200,000 people type thing. If you were to like think of this as an actual city. Actually, I take that back, maybe about 45, 50,000 here. So, oh yeah, close to what we have. Okay, so never mind. Maybe the game's not that unrealistic. Okay, so now we have a whole ton of trees. Check this out. When I start a forest fire, this is insanity.
The Forest Service has stated that there is a risk of an imminent forest fire in the area. Residents are advised
this
to avoid forested areas.
25 tile mod, I love that one. That's actually one of the first ones I used too. I was so hesitant to use mods in the beginning. Now it's like I love them, but just when they announced the Natural Disasters DLC, I knew that everything was going to be all messed up, so I kind of switched over to all the vanilla series and I've been playing vanilla on Steam and
a
stuff,
forest
or on Twitch.
Fire is raging in the area. Leave campsites and tree houses immediately.
I'm excited to go back to playing with mods, but I'm enjoying just playing without them. There's a lot of stuff I want to do, like change traffic lights, set up like lane arrows. Look at how insane this is. Like, what on earth is going on here? Oh yeah, I know the game. I can't even believe it's such good value. It's like on super sale right now. Poor helicopters. So you can see like a forest fire if you have a lot of trees, or if you're doing this in town a lot, like it's not, it's no joke, right? All right, so let's like this will eventually grow back and this might burn itself out because you can kind of see like the trees were only really thick over there. And no, darn it, our fire spread over to here now. Oh, great. Okay, here comes the fire department. Boy, oh boy, oh boy, things are really falling apart in our poor city. Yes, fire department saving the day. Yeah, I know what you mean. There's a lot of like camping grounds, like
a
that kind of stuff too.
A forest fire is raging in the area. Leave campsites and tree houses immediately.
But I've noticed a colossal order over the last year or two. They've integrated quite a few of the more popular mods. And I don't think that's really out of the question for, you know, some to come. Okay, let's build a new highway interchange over here, because I just can't stand all this traffic. It's driving me bonkers. That was kind of neat, though. So yeah, over time, this will grow back, and, oh, that's cool, they're going outside of city boundaries. That's good to know. And then the, like, the burnt zone, everything goes away, too. You're replaced with fresh soil. Okay, so let's come at it. Like, I don't want to, I would like a six-lane road to kind of come through here. And I think it would be kind of neat to bring maybe even more trains in and just have even more of a kind of a train yard feel. This is not bad, but it's kind of weirdly sloped, so I don't know if this is necessarily even what I was going for per se. So these can be maybe endpoints, just so we don't have to worry too much about all these bridges and stuff. Hey, Cheeseburger, what's up, man? Welcome, welcome, welcome. No, I'm not gonna worry about that just yet. So let's, yeah, six lane street this. Cool. That's just cool in general. But where is this gonna go? That's not really practical, I guess, then. Unless we do something like that. Oh, yeah, why not? Okay, I see. We do have a 6-lane road over here. Okay. Does that look kind of nice? Yeah, I think so. I don't see why not.
Good to have you back.
Yeah, we're getting, I mean, traffic, I don't know, it's not the best in this city. Normally I do a better job. I'm kind of slacking for some reason. So, I mean, it's around here. Just gonna be a lot of, like, you know, industry and stuff happening, so. And not enough highway access.
Our rival Plato 880 at 88.4. As classics.
There we go, that's better. I love, honestly, the banter on the radio stations. I think they're so silly. Vibes, honestly, I personally am having a lot of fun with it. But, like, knowing Colossal Order, this will definitely go on sale. But, like, for me, like, the main thing, I have so much fun with this. Like, all the new helicopter stuff and everything and disasters in general. And it hasn't gotten stale yet for me either, and I've been playing, like, consistently for, I guess, like, a week plus now. So I personally think it's definitely worth it, but it will go on sale soon. So if you're willing to wait, you know, you can wait it out, type thing. So my thought is, you know, if you wait, it's on sale, you can pick up more DLCs, type thing. Okay, so what we could do... Sorry, guys, I'm recording all morning, so I'm losing my poor voice here. Is I'm gonna make a partial cloverleaf interchange here. I think those have been serving us pretty well. I'm probably going to stream some Rust tomorrow. I don't think I'm going to be doing a double stream today. And also, I just have so much stuff I want to record still. I'm on a pretty good roll with that, but there's just so many more things I need. I got a lot of projects on the go right now, it seems. I need a road to kind of go underneath here. We'll get to a waterfall eventually. Highway interchange first. Yeah, I'll show you guys, yeah, those new water buildings or whatever. So I don't even know if these are popular in Europe or if they're even in Europe, but like partial cloverleaf interchanges are like all the rage in North America. And personally, I think they're very efficient. I can see why roundabouts are obviously used, and it's kind of tricky to get a really good, efficient one working in this game, but when this is done properly, I think this works well with the game. Oh gosh, you want to be moist now? Oh my lord, what do I even say to that? Should never have told you guys in the first place of my strangeness with that word. I'm like one of those people that's like part of the population that thinks like the word moist is like a naughty word. That's why everyone always uses it in, you know, in chat. So the idea here is if you're going onto the highway, if you're coming, you know, from the bridge, you turn right, go down this way, and then that way you don't have to turn in front of anyone that wants to go on the highway that way. So you're not really slowing traffic down, you know, traffic that wants to just go straight through can without getting impeded either. And then we'll have the way off. That's kind of neat too, I think. Sort of. I wonder if we can get a little bit more concrete. Kinda. Nope, that's too much. Oh! Oh my goodness. I was like, what did you just type? But then I see a little typo. Okay, I want to switch to, yeah, there we go. I just don't like how the grounds, kind of, there, I think that's it. Yes. Yes. exactly it. Cool. Like, I didn't want to lose, like, the curb lane or whatever. It, like, turned to grass or whatever, had that weird overlay. Cool. Oh, wait, what? Why did you... No, don't ban him. God, it's a typo. You don't have to ban him, silly. Oh, did Nightbot? Wait, what happened? What happened to Nightbot? What have you guys done here? I'm not even, what have you guys done to my poor chat? Are you guys destroying things? All right, well, let's work on this side while I figure out what the heck's going on over there. Okay. This might I probably do the exit from the tunnel a little bit underground. So this one might be a little bit trickier to do than the one we just made, but I think we can get this. As much as I do hate Nightbot, Nightbot does kind of help sometimes. Not that much room to work with. I hate, like, trying to find, like, the snap points. There we go. Nope. I may have to delete a segment of highway here just so I can get closer. No, I don't think we have enough room in here. There we go. So our goal is just to get the highway... to kind of work with this now, oh boy. Not quite. That's a bit better. But even that can probably curve a little bit more. There we go. Okay, that's basically this one reconnected. That probably could be a little bit smoother. So actually, no, I'm not gonna bother. That's gonna take too long. That really isn't all that bad looking anyway. Cool. Oh, don't tell me. Really? After all that, really? Ah, oh, darn it. No, this is really... That was really annoying after all that. Darn it. Sorry, guys. Didn't mean to waste that couple minutes right there. There we go. The irony could have done that. Well, I guess we couldn't have because the highway was still in the way. I'm just trying to get a little bit of this clipped off so I can change that curve, and that's what I'm after. There we go. That took way longer than it needed to. It's actually going to last a little bit longer. Alright, Mr. Duck, I will see you later. Yeah, it's pretty late for you probably too, right? See, that's what I was trying to get away from, just by doing what we did with the double row like that. There we go. Gives us more concrete. And it looks like a little bit neater, I think, kind of coming in. Oh, that's nice. There we go. Cool, new interchange. Okay, so we need other types of helicopters. And we actually need a prison system too still. Holy smokes, a lot to do. These are police helicopters, obviously to help patrol and deal with crime. These again, just temporary locations. And another interchange that totally fell apart during a whole bunch of traffic was this one right here. So this possibly has to be changed. I thought it was kind of neat looking and just interesting, but apparently it doesn't really do too well. All right, Ishii, best of luck, man. Let's drop a few more people too, really quickly. Oh, I didn't put this frontage down as housing. There we go. Just gonna drop in a few services up here too. Police, I mean, we're probably good to be honest for coverage, but just in case. This is probably too big to fit over here, just given the slope. Oh, I take that back. Okay. Actually, we'll leave it in. We'll just see how this ends up looking with buildings coming in. But I'm going to switch it over to houses, just so it doesn't get drowned out. Oops. And these can now, I think, move. I don't really think we need these. A bit noisy for our residents. And these initially were just helping move power around, but now the city is kind of pretty connected on its own, so a lot of this stuff just becomes redundant. So power is still good. Awesome. That'll make people happier. And I mean, might as well just make sure these are connected to something. So I have one more in there. There we go. That completes the chain. Are there good mod packs? Oh yeah, a lot of people have gone through the effort of creating on the Steam Workshop like asset collections, and they'll have like just kind of a theme to them type thing, and they might have like say like 15, 20, 30 buildings or whatever. I remember this wanting, I wanted to change this around too. I'm gonna do that right now though. This looks like an awesome hit. Look how much better traffic is. Beautiful. Still pretty high volume over here, but happy with that. Okay, let's test out some more disasters. I'm excited to drop some more stuff in. I think the city's in a better spot than it was when we first started the stream. Most definitely. That's a cool looking interchange. All right. Kinda, I like that. That's the right kind of backed up too and everything. Yeah, it's nice. Okay, let's blow up some stuff. Yeah, so for those of you who missed it earlier, you can see this is now grown back, but just holy heck, right?
The Forest Service has stated that there is a risk of an imminent forest fire in the area. Residents are advised to avoid forested areas.
This isn't actually full enough yet to, I should save it before I blow it up? Well, I'm not going to, like, blow it up completely, but I'm going to drop a few disasters. I guess this hasn't filled back in enough to really present a big issue. But, I'll kind of show you guys. So, right here, you can see the fire. Nothing special. That one helicopter totally took care of it. We burned this entire area to the ground a little bit earlier, and like really not too long ago, and it really burned to the ground. Trees are in the process of growing back. If you have a super tight density of trees like this, the fire will spread so quickly. So we're going to just test some stuff in the city, and I want to just make a little corridor along, say, some of the streets, and I want to see what kind of damage that will do. We started testing that out in the last one, but I think we got impatient and blew some stuff up. Yeah, the helicopter department, yeah. Well, that's what they're getting paid for. But yeah, you can imagine their frustration. If immediately after the forest regrows, that it burns right back down. Actually, we need to be over here still.
The Forest Service has stated that there is a risk of an imminent forest fire in the area.
Everything is like
residents
tense,
are advised
dense
to avoid forested areas.
Like super forested, you can see like the fire really spreads. So if you have in your own cities, kind of like along a highway or like, you know, in this whole area here. Oh gosh, just pulls us over there. Sorry, guys. So like, yeah, say for example, all in this valley, this whole thing, if this was all trees.
A forest fire is raging in the area. Leave campsites and tree houses immediately.
Yeah, it's Monday where Duck is. Duck's in the future, guys. You can ask him for like lottery numbers and all that other stuff and he'll tell you, I think. But yeah, this is cool, right? Anyway, so when this grows back in, it'll be even more dense. But I want to try that in town, and I wanted to see what would happen. So maybe we can even use this as our little test area. I want to see if it'll spread to buildings, and then maybe we can put some trees on this. So let's see how much of a fire we can create here. Because fires, to a certain extent, are easy to come back from. We have, like, sinkholes and meteors and stuff. That, you know, that's a little challenging. We do have random disasters on. Nothing struck yet, so why don't we turn the frequency to say half or a little bit higher. So I think we're kind of asking for some trouble now, but just, you know, have a little fun. And I'm not using auto saves or anything, so it's, you know, we're pressing our luck, but I think in a fun way. Let's see what happens here. Yeah, I thought about using like even the tree brush or something, but I don't mind. Like, I'm still trying to keep this like a mod-free series. More or less, I can plant trees pretty quickly anyhow. But there's just so many mods, like you can just kind of see how they were created or why. It's like tree brush mod, like a lot of the anarchy mods, like even just precision engineering, just like a simple one. So yeah, let's just fill this entire valley in, we'll start a fire, let that kind of spread. We can even turn the day-night cycle on, and what we can do to really get some fires going is we can start a few thunderstorms and maybe have a tornado. I don't know, we'll see how we're feeling about that. You guys maybe give your thoughts on that. This will take me just a few minutes to do. As a bonus, this will look pretty nice when it's not on fire. But yeah, I'm just kind of curious, like, will it, you know, jump from building to building? Will it make its way over to, like, this hill and then spread up here and then burn down all the buildings up there? What will happen? Oh, yeah, of course I'll continue that for sure. Most definitely. I actually recorded an episode of that this morning, so I'll have that released tomorrow. I was trying to marathon record this morning. I kept running into a couple problems, though. A few distractions and some noises and stuff, mainly cats. They have a tendency to just come in right at the worst moment and just, you know. So, I mean, in general, I try to, like, not, you know, kick them out of the house or whatever, let them cruise around outside, but tough when winter's approaching. I mean, all things considering, besides us trying to blow up the city right now, I think the city's coming along rather nicely. And it would be cool to get to the unlock for the airport. I think that population milestone is like 70,000, though, so it's a ways to go. Yeah, 70,000. You effectively have to like double the city size almost. That's a challenge. Okay, I think we have enough trees around here that the fire should spread. I don't see why I want it at this point. And so let's just see, will it even go like underneath the bridges? You know, like that kind of stuff, right? How far and how wide and how terrifying will be the damage. There, it's probably good. Oh, and we don't have any medical helicopters in. Let's probably put a few of those down. And I'm not going to go the whole way because that would just be, you know, take way too long. Probably a temporary spot, just like the other ones. So I want to make like a little area specifically for like emergency like slash like disaster response. Just use hang on right there for a second. Okay, that's probably good. All right, so let's test out our fire over here. Let's see what happens. Or wait, let's take it another step here. Let's do day nights. Yes, very nice. Excellent. And then I wanted to do a thunderstorm. That's right. Some garbage collection. What a lovely city. Shame we're gonna have to do some stuff right now. Oh, Bloodthirsty Cheeseburger, don't be dramatic. We love you. Okay. I'm gonna start the fire here. So, thunderstorm, because anywhere there's like a lightning strike, that will make a
meteorologists are issuing a thunderstorm warning for the coming days.
A little fire.
Citizens are advised to stay indoors.
Let's start a fire right there.
The Forest Service has stated that there is a risk of an imminent forest fire in the area. Residents are advised to avoid forested areas.
Okay, let's see what happens
A
here.
Forest fire is raging in the area. Leave campsites and tree houses immediately.
Yeah, exactly. Definitely, yeah. So Planet Coaster, I'll stream that sometimes. I stream Rust here and there. DayZ, I've been known to stream that sometimes. And Transport Fever, I started streaming that recently, too. My only scheduled stream is I do the City Skylines every Sunday 2 p.m. type thing, unless there's like something that kind of comes up, but I'm usually pretty consistent with that. Oh good, it goes underneath the bridge, so we're after right there. Not that, oh good, because the city's on fire, but like I'm just curious right now, right? And just, you know, in general, like I'm trying to put more effort into just, you know, Twitch and YouTube and just, you know, trying to put more games out there and like that kind of stuff, so. You can always, you know, send me a whisper or like leave me a comment on one of my videos on a game you want to see, that kind of thing. Not opposed to trying new stuff out. Oh, awesome.
A thunderstorm is battering the city. Stay indoors until the storm has passed.
So this will start some fires. Let's just sit back and enjoy this for a minute. I also have a few series kind of on the go right now for YouTube. All of which I kind of have to catch up on and make some more content and everything. I'm gonna fire over here now. So it looks like the fire never went underneath the highway this way to go up towards the hill. End of the world in this city. Yeah, it seems very dramatic, doesn't it? But the lightning, I think, is such a nice touch.
A forest fire is raging in the area. Leave campsites and tree houses immediately.
Yeah, with the new fire mechanics, like the fire, it just spreads from building to building. So here we go. That's what I was kind of curious about. It's awesome. Helicopters. Yeah, it's a fun little DLC, I think. That'd be cool, Billy. They like trade with other cities. If there were some aspect to like a multiplayer, like you could all maybe play on like a region or something together, kind of like what SimCity was trying to do, but they never really quite got it right, unfortunately. That would be really neat though. And if they had like first person vehicle mods, you could like theoretically drive down the highway to your friend's city. It'd be so cool. Imagine they were like down there. You'd be like, howdy neighbor. Or you could do like disaster management, because I mean all of that, it almost happened with SimCity, but they just didn't get it right, and they had like a million years to kind of do that too. Thunderstruck AC/DC, that'd be kind of cool playing in the background, right? Classical music though, kind of, I think it's nice. Ooh, hello. Storm's going on forever. I think the tornadoes as well just look absolutely fantastic. But here, let's try, I mean, is this area up and running again? Just so we can burn it down? I mean, kind of.
The Forest Service has stated that there is a risk of an imminent forest fire in the area. Residents are advised to avoid forested areas.
Oh, this thing's on fire. Oh, goodness. Oh, see, like this, how would this get put out? Would you need, I guess, with the fire department come?
The Forest Service has stated that there is a risk of an imminent forest fire in the area. Residents are advised to avoid forested areas.
Am I Canadian? Oh, you betcha.
A forest fire is raging in the area.
I'm as Canadian as they get, my friend.
Leave campsites and tree houses immediately.
Yeah, I live in Toronto. And I'm from Ottawa, our nation's capital. Oh, this is like so much better than SimCity. And I was gonna do a SimCity series. Cause I mean the game, even though it wasn't the best, there's aspects of it I kind of enjoyed. So I do want to do a short little SimCity 2013 series, and maybe just fill a region in SimCity 4. Kind of stream that a little bit here and there. That might maybe be more of a YouTube project, though. We'll kind of see. Yeah, the planes, fire planes would be so cool. But this poor radio tower, I think that's just going to burn down, right? Because I feel like you almost need like a like road access. So you can get a fire truck in here. I'm just curious to see if one will get dispatched. I don't think so, though. That might be close enough to a road that theoretically... Oh yeah, maybe, that's could be coming our way. And what the heck? This is so crazy. I love these forest fires.
A forest fire is raging in the area. Leave campsites and tree houses immediately.
Oh, awesome. Yeah, look at this. So there we go. Good to note. We saved it. Yeah, that's the other thing too. You have to be kind of online with your friends and you got to be diligent and everything. But that's like a lot of online video games are like that though. If you're kind of base sharing or whatever, you have to just stick it out.
A forest fire is raging in the area. Leave campsites and tree houses immediately.
But it'd just be so insanely awesome if they had like a North American server or like a European server or just whatever, and you just hop in and it was like just this, but like times 100, like an actual, like, you know, cruising through like the country map or whatever, and you just, you know, set up shop.
A forest fire is raging in the area. Leave campsites and tree houses immediately.
I just wouldn't want there to be like that struggle for like space though. I'd still want to kind of stretch my legs, try some stuff out, have oversized interchanges, not really worry about my neighbors being like, oh, look at this guy, using up all that space to make this weird clover leaf. I'd be like, but guys, look at it, it's so cool. So, yeah, the fire is definitely pretty at night. This game just at night is so nice. I like this interchange. I like the song, oh, so nice. Daylights, have we recovered from all this? Okay. Let's, I don't know, let's try another disaster here. I'm gonna do a tornado just on the outskirts so we can kind of see it. I don't really want to blow it up in the city though. And like our last stream has turned into that. Just progressively we just destroyed the place, but I don't want to do that. Why don't we come through maybe just a little bit over here? Just so we can kind of see what some of the buildings look like destroyed.
Meteorologists have issued a severe tornado warning for the area.
And what's a tornado?
Residents should seek shelter immediately if any is available. Meteorologists are issuing a thunderstorm warning for the coming days. And citizens are advised to stay indoors. The Forest Service has stated that there is a risk of an imminent forest fire in the area.
Right,
residents
this is definitely
are advised
going now.
To avoid forested areas.
Yeah, I played like SimCity 4. I played that in the area. Forever.
Leave campsites and tree houses immediately.
Oh my goodness. That would be terrible. A meteor coming down and just... Yeah, if you have disasters too, actually. Yeah, if you're sharing regions and you have disasters on all the time, then like, oh my gosh. You just have to make sure you're watching your neighbor's city and everything. Holy heck, you guys. What the heck? This is insane. Like, this is what I was curious about, right? Like, how far will it spread into the buildings? Looks like it just hit a whole wave of them. Look, all the fire departments coming. Oh, this is so cool. All the fire trucks coming. Even more backup from across the city. Here comes the helicopters. Yeah, boy. I wonder if they can contain this. You know what's really scary to think? There's like a tornado on its way too. All of a sudden the clouds are gonna kind of come in and it's gonna be really... It's gonna be bad. Why not an earthquake? Oh my gosh. Earthquakes, those are really damaging because they just bring down a whole bunch of buildings and roads and stuff. Oh gosh. Maybe we can have a little one over here. And they create fault lines too. Like, I want to do an earthquake on the outskirt, but we don't really have an outskirt. Can I buy another tile? I feel like I can. Oh, yeah. Let's buy this one here so we can make our harbor. And I'm just going to do an earthquake over here. I don't really want to lose too much, though. Yeah, just over here. Why not? What part would you like me to zoom in on? I kind of want to see the fire. Or... Oh, here comes the tornado. Oh, gosh.
A tornado has touched down in the area. Seek shelter immediately if
this
any is available.
Is insane. Like the
thunderstorm is battering the
city. Game will like auto zoom in and kind of track a disaster. So when you drop a few down, your camera might just kind of go crazy. So like, oh, it destroyed our stadium. Oh no, I didn't think about that. You end up with like a lot of rubble and like back on and stuff until these cars are being destroyed. And I mean, the tornado is extraordinarily destructive. Harbor, I'm not gonna have a city
a
left. Yeah,
I
think you might be right about that.
Leave campsites and tree houses immediately.
But no, we're gonna try and come back from this. This is not too much disaster. I think we're up for the challenge too. So it looks like the fire's been put out, so way to go team. Probably some new fires starting with the thunderstorm right now.
Warning. Experts predict an earthquake could hit the area soon.
Oh gosh. Earthquake's next on the list of things that's gonna go crazy. And see, a fault line will open, and you'll kind of see like all the shaking and stuff happen. The camera will probably bring us over there when it happens, so let's just watch this until it does. But that's a decent line of destruction, though. It even looks like a hurricane or a tornado's kind of path. And then that's probably what the issue was last time around. So it's like these things here you have to clear by yourself, otherwise the roads are always going to be like this. I think it's a matter of just upgrading. Yeah, there we go. You gotta upgrade your roads to repair them. That unfortunately doesn't happen automatically. That's cool. A helicopter just landing on the ground right there and everything. Oh my gosh. Oh, I'm doing the wrong. Oh no, I'm doing terrible amounts of damage here. I need these to be trams, I believe. Oh, earthquake. Let's go watch that. It might open up a fault line.
An earthquake is occurring.
It just might happen underwater.
Don't panic and wait for help if you are in the affected
area. Yeah, it is
area.
Opening the fault line underwater. You can see where the water is kind of. As a bonus, it'll create a tsunami, which is kind of cool. Place a 10 severity earthquake in the water. Okay, I guess that's. Why not? Let's create a nice big.
A tornado has touched down in the area. Seek shelter immediately if any is available.
Look at this water physics. That's awesome, though, right? So, yeah, if you have an earthquake hit over land, it just kind of opens up like a fissure. Oh, gosh, what is going on over here? All right, so let's. What I was doing there by accident is I upgraded some of the roads, and I. Unfortunately, took the tram tracks off because I just didn't realize what I was doing. So I want to go ahead and fix that now. I don't think we had tram tracks going this way. We did not, but it would be kind of cool to bring those in. Sorry, guys. Slight sidetrack. I'm just going to get our trams and everyone up and running again. Unfortunately, yeah, I wish there was a way to, because you have to, like, do your repair with the right type of road, it looks like, otherwise, yeah. Alright, so that's trams over here. Make that just like that temporarily. I think that's sort of connected. Oh my gosh, there's so much to do here. I just want our public transit to start rolling again. That's kind of my number one priority right now. These are just regular roads. Because I was thinking, like, last time we were trying this out last stream, was that you just put down one of the these repair buildings right here, and that these guys would just go through and just kind of take care of all the maintenance needs. But unfortunately, they do not. Oh, I still haven't done my waterfall yet. I appreciate you reminding me. Yes, I wish this was automatic. Because it's slightly inconvenient having to switch between, it needs to be, oh, cool, it has to be searched by disaster. Oh, that's cool. Alright, 3 speeds back on. I think our transit vehicles should be rolling again.
A forest fire is raging in the area. Leave campsites and tree houses immediately.
I want to see what route that is and why it hasn't found its... Oh, I see. This has to be moved over to there. Okay, I gotcha. Oh wait, no, that
Warning.
Was two separate routes.
Experts
okay, we're okay.
Experts predict an earthquake could hit the area soon.
Oh, here's our mega earthquake in the water.
An earthquake is occurring. Don't panic and wait for help if you are in the affected area.
Oh, and actually last week too, we noticed, I'm just gonna try this as well. When we threw in a tsunami, I only had it on the default 5.5, and it wasn't even enough to kind of crest over this little hill. I'm actually gonna see what a tsunami of like 10 power would do. I guess we could probably use another one of these buildings. Possibly a temporary location, but I'm still gonna put that down right now. Oh, is that cool? Our power lines. Oh, look at that. Why am I so fascinated by this game? Poopquake? Yeah, a little bit of one. Now that you mention it. Yeah, we gotta clean up this. Like, this is kinda looking pretty bad. Yeah, I guess by that same logic, it's gonna be like a poop tsunami kinda coming in too. That's no good. Alright, well, let me turn off our day-night cycle, and let's start trying to rebuild from this. And we still have random disasters on, and we still haven't had one hit us. Or maybe some of those fires in town have been disasters, we just didn't know it. And oh my gosh, what is going on here? What transport route is that? I think this is probably for the emergency shelter. I wouldn't be surprised if that's... Yeah, five severity, I kind of agree, doesn't really... See, this is what happened, like, the roads, they just kind of come to a standstill. And I wonder if it has to do with the fact that all of these are, like, just damaged roads or whatever. Okay, well, let's start cleaning up. It's like, there should be a repair button, because this just makes me nervous, because I feel like I'm gonna not use the right road again at some point. Okay. Time-consuming effort, but something we must do in order to get the city up and running. And the tsunami, it'll take a few minutes for it to arrive anyway. We'll get the warning and the camera will hop on over, so... Just keep ourselves busy with this. Oh, that was trees. Oh, wait. Like, see, I'm so confused. I had this one selected, right? And it still kept the trees. Oh, gosh, I don't know now. It's like the first click for repair, and then the next click, is that for an upgrade? It is. Okay, so I've been complaining about nothing this entire time. I just double-clicked probably in some spots. Okay, so forget what I was saying earlier. The game is wonderful again. No problems here. Well, that's really good to know. I would just be cautious about doing a, like, you know, a click and drag then. Nice. Yeah, this makes so much more sense. That's actually, this is manageable. Oh, I've been meaning to try that, doing a drained lake kind of build, or like you kind of take over part of the sea. On my list of to-do things, or things to do, I guess is the word I'm looking for. All right, what roads are still in need of fixing? Hey, our stadium is back, cool. Like, do we do the same thing for pathways? What do we do? How fascinating. Then how do we repair these, I wonder? Or is it just a matter of restringing these? Looks like he's gotta restring them. These probably are redundant now, so we don't even need them. And I can't rebuild until we get a survey team through there, which is taking a while, looks like. Well, I mean, yeah, the chaos is starting to kind of go away, sort of. Oh, highway, this highway. Yes, 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 yes. Thank you, guys. Yeah, of course. I wish there was like an icon you could click on that would bring you to an area that needed repair or whatever.
Welcome back.
And let's switch stations. Let's listen to City Radio. Otherwise, I think that's it for roads. You guys see anything else I'm missing here? And then hopefully it's just a matter of time for these to kind of figure themselves out and traffic to kind of go back to normal.
The Coast Guard is warning of a tsunami approaching the area.
Finally.
Residents should avoid roads and waterfronts.
Whoa, that is a wall of water.
The tsunami has struck the city. Take caution and avoid roads and waterfronts until the water recedes.
Yeah, when we did like a 5.5, it didn't even make up this hill. Like, it just barely did it. Oh my gosh, this is insanity. Holy wow. Well, rest in peace our cargo area. Hey, Lionsbane, what's up, man? Happy to have you here, my friend. Wow, that's massive. You can see the fault lines that we created earlier from our earthquake, too. I don't think it's gonna have much more momentum than this, though. I think it might make it to the highway and then it's gonna kind of fizzle out. Because this is like pretty, it gets deep right here. So I think this might just kind of act like a, just kind of like a bottleneck for the water anyway. It's all gonna fall into this. Now, why are we all backed up right here? Tell me your secrets before you all get washed away. Don't you care? Don't you have rearview mirrors? Don't you see what's happening, people? Take it back. Maybe it'll make it past the highway. A lot of momentum in this water here.
A tsunami has struck the city. Take caution and avoid roads and waterfronts until the water recedes.
Man, this thing is just moving. No, it's losing the battle now. And so yeah, what you could theoretically do to prevent tsunami damage from being... Oh my gosh, what on earth just happened here? What? Wow. So I guess to prevent this, what we could have done is set up a series of canals and spillways and maybe some emergency pumps or something. And then we could use like the outflow pipes.
A tsunami has struck the city.
And this could be kind of like the start of our little makeshift. I want to try this again now.
The Forest Service has stated that there is a risk of an imminent forest fire in the area. Residents are advised to avoid forested areas.
Holy heck. This is, yeah, but I mean, way more powerful than I thought it was going to be. It's still moving. Look at this thing go. All these poor trains. Okay, yeah, so let's try a little spillway or something. I'm actually curious here. So we'd basically be empty until
a tsunami
or something
hits. A tsunami has struck the city. Take caution and avoid roads and waterfronts until the water recedes.
Would this look really silly, though? I think it might, just having these giant empty canal basins or whatever, just waiting for, you know, disaster to strike. Not only that, it's gonna fill with water anyway. Yeah, I don't think that's the right approach. Let's think this one through. I mean, theoretically, we could have a few that cut across. It just looks so strange.
A tsunami
though.
Has struck the city. Take caution and avoid
the shallow ones.
And
I don't even think they would
the water recedes.
Do enough to kind of prevent anything. Because, yeah, there's nothing really stopping these from just filling up from water from the lake already, right? Well, I mean, let's just try stuff. We can always just erase it. I'm just kind of curious now to see what would happen here if we set up like a little spillway for water to kind of make its way back out to the coast or whatever.
A tsunami has struck the city. Take caution and avoid roads and waterfronts until the water recedes.
So just, yeah, hypothetically, this is like a system that water would now like run all the way back downhill towards the coast. And it's like, what would it look like if we did maybe even this? Take that, Mother Nature. Yeah, what are the, I mean, what would coastal defenses even do and look like and stuff against the tsunami? I wish there was an easier and cleaner way to transition in and out of these.
A tsunami has struck the city. Take caution and avoid roads and waterfronts until the water recedes.
Like, that's so silly. We're not doing that. Maybe we can terraform so that this kind of works a bit in our favor. It doesn't really want to do that either. Nah, darn it. Alright, never mind. That's also what I want to avoid, too. All this ponded and stuff, right? Oh, you're watching from Australia? Oh, cool. Well, howdy, Fadas. Greetings from Canada. Good old Canada.
A tsunami has struck the city. Take caution and avoid roads and waterfronts until the water recedes.
All right, well, before we do any rebuilding or anything over here, let's test this out. Like, I don't think this is really enough to stop a tsunami. I think we might need something on the other side too, but let's just see what this would look like and what'll happen when we have something like this in place. This looks a little bit silly, that's all. It's probably not going to be permanent, but again, just to kind of test some stuff out. Oops.
A tsunami has struck the city. Take caution and avoid roads and waterfronts until the water recedes.
Okay, so another massive tsunami. Power factor 10. Let's just bash the coast. And we'll just see if this makes like a noticeable improvement. Because it's funneling a lot of the water out. I think possibly we should get deep on that side. Let more water out a little more aggressively. Let me just change that a little bit here. There we go. What other natural disasters exist? Well, a very good question, my friend. We've got the option for a sinkhole, a tornado, an earthquake, a lightning storm, forest fire, building collapse, regular fire, meteor strike, and tsunami. And the forest fires are like horrifyingly awesome. Oh, no, our tower. How are we gonna
call
for
help? The Forest Service has stated that there is a risk of an imminent forest fire in the area. Residents
are advised
to avoid forested
areas.
A forest fire is raging in the area. Leave campsites and tree houses immediately.
That's pretty nuts. And it only spreads that quickly if you have, like, trees that are very, very close to one another. So we can do the same thing over here. And that area will eventually grow back, and we were doing the same thing over in this spot. I was just testing some stuff out a bit earlier, and I was just getting carried away in a fun way. Yeah, we want that to kind of spread a bit more. I enjoy fire for some reason. I think I'm a pyromaniac, and I just didn't realize it yet. So this DLC, if nothing else, has been a real self-awakening, right? So yeah, I want to spread some fire around over here. then we can do, let's bring the day-night cycle back on. Let's just have a little bit more fun right here.
The Forest Service has stated that there is a risk of an imminent forest fire in the area.
I will not, however, bring
area.
Another Residents tornado are advised in, because I think it's a little to bit too much forested chaos. Areas.
Meteorologists are issuing a thunderstorm warning for the coming days.
Oh, we should be
Citizens are advised
people...
to stay
I'm
indoors.
Activating the emergency shelters so people can now go into
A forest fire is raging
them.
In the area. Leave campsites and tree houses immediately.
And I'm going to keep it on 3-speed... just because I want this to kind of figure itself out and settle before the tsunami comes. Just to kind of see if this actually has an impact. Oh, interesting enough, it looks like the helicopters can get water from the canal. Oh, that's cool.
A forest fire is raging in the area.
And the fire you can
these
see spread to
and
the, these buildings.
Immediately.
Oh, is Girlfriend Jedi here? Oh, did I miss that? I'll feel really bad if I did. Oh, she's not here. Oh yeah, so you fooled me too now. You got all of our hopes up for nothing. I hope you're happy with yourself. Twitch chat should be a disaster. Oh my gosh. Oh wow, look at that.
A thunderstorm is
Ooh,
battering
boy.
The city. Stay indoors until the storm has passed.
But again, the fire, it didn't jump over up until this hill, or up into this hill, which is what I kind of wanted it to do, so let's just help it.
The Forest Service has stated that there is a risk of an imminent forest fire in the area. Residents are advised to avoid
And the lightning strikes
areas.
Will cause,
A forest fire is raging in the
area.
Leave campsites and tree houses immediately.
Oh, she is here! Oh! Well, hello there. Welcome, welcome. Guys, a celebrity has entered the chats, Miss Girlfriend Jedi. Yeah, plot twist, exactly.
She's been here all along.
That's cool. I love the way that spreads. And just, that looks horrifying. Especially with all, like, the chaos with the lightning and everything behind it, right? Oh my goodness, look at these fire trucks.
A forest fire is raging in the area. Leave campsites and tree houses immediately.
Okay, where's this tsunami? I feel like that's probably not too far off. Oh gosh, here it is. Oh, look at this wall of water. This is nothing. We're ill prepared for this.
Meteorologists are issuing a thunderstorm warning for the coming days. Citizens are advised to stay indoors.
Oh my goodness, you're also funny.
A forest fire is raging in the area. Leave campsites and tree houses
One little
immediately.
Fire right here. Alright, well this whole area is about to get flattened by a wall of water again. And we can kind of see what's going to happen. I might just turn the day-night off, just so we can kind of see this here. Oh my goodness, look at this wall of water. Oh wow. Hey JBS, what's up? I'm playing God here?
Yes, my child.
A forest fire
yeah, you mean
is
your father,
raging
exactly.
in the area. Leave campsites and tree houses immediately.
Oh, actually, that strangely did quite a bit of good. Well, look at that. How about that? Yeah. You can see the momentum still pushed a lot of the water over, but I'd say that was like a very big difference.
The Coast Guard is warning of a tsunami approaching the area. Residents should avoid roads
this
and waterfronts.
Completely useless.
A tsunami has struck the city.
As if it's not even
Take
there.
Take caution and avoid roads and waterfronts until the water recedes.
No, very Admiral, definitely ill-prepared. I keep forgetting how serious of an intensity a number 10 is. We could probably survive like a 5 or less like so comfortably right now. But yeah, I'd say like noticeable difference on this side. And you can see it's pulling a lot of the water back already. So arguably, if this went a little bit further in, we'd probably do a better job. Like, our city doesn't really suffer too much from tsunamis because we have that, like, really just deep kind of river canal thing going in between it already. Just these, I mean, they don't look too hideous, to be honest. It's actually growing on me a little bit more, especially we can kind of work some industry in with it.
The city.
They just don't really
Take
seem to do
and avoid
like,
roads
that much.
And waterfronts until the water recedes.
You kind of get a small warning for the tsunami, but it's like effectively not enough. You get, like, you can put down little warning buoys. I think we have a few of those kind of here and there. I think we need some further back, actually. Yeah, let's drop one over there. That boat's like, nope, I'll come back later, thank you. Well, I think we survived. See, this helps with getting the water back out fast.
A tsunami has struck the city. Take caution and avoid roads and waterfronts until the water recedes.
It would be, like, nice to have some water flowing in this constantly. So maybe we can have, like, a waterfall thing? It's finally time to make one, I think. Maybe, yes. Meteor? Oh my gosh. Alright, fine. I'll do it. But I'm not going to have it strike the city, because I like our city. I'm going to have it strike somewhere not as useful. Oh my gosh, everyone's dying. Our poor coast, we were just battering the crap out of it, but here comes another
Astrologists one. Report that a devastating meteor will strike the city in the near future. Residents should seek shelter immediately strike. If any is available. A tsunami has struck the city. Take caution and avoid roads and waterfronts until the water recedes. Astrologists report that a devastating meteor will strike the city in the near future. Residents should seek shelter immediately
if any
is available.
Is I'm gonna maybe expand, I think, a bit on this canal. Are we close to an unlock? Oh my gosh.
Insurance, the last insurance you'll ever need.
Kaboom!
A meteor strike has
caught me a little bit off guard.
Avoid the impact site and head to shelter if any is available.
Boom. That'll do some massive terraforming.
A meteor strike has occurred. Avoid the impact site and head to shelter if any is available.
I want to start a little fire here too.
Hi, Alex.
A tsunami has struck the city. Take caution and avoid roads and waterfronts until the water recedes.
We are the leading producer of minerals, ore,
oh, it broke
and
our canal. What?
Which means you're benefiting.
How did that happen?
Services, whether you know us or not.
How fascinating.
No matter what our critics say, at Colossal, we care about our employees as well as
I love
our
these,
customers.
Like the radio banter. It's like my favorite.
So hard to get our miners back.
Yeah, definitely like a nuke went off. Holy, and look at all this water still back here. Darn it. I need that to evaporate.
The people who love them.
But yeah, I would love to buy this tile right here and then like work a waterfall into like this spot so that we can have some like actual outflow so this can actually be full of water all the time. But I'm going to keep maybe this side maybe not. All right, well let's try and recover from this because I think we've just been blowing the city up too much right now because look at our poor place, right? Okay, so helicopter depot, let's start rebuilding some things here. I think our roads are in decent shape. It's just getting rid of all the dead bodies, which is kind of morbid. These are just homes. Yeah, homes. Oh, a road here. Just a few roads. Crater lakes are the best lakes? Oh, maybe we can create a crater lake then. You guys want to try that? Is that the best way to deal with this, do you think? Because, you know, it'd be really nice. Like, that's a farmer's field. So we can have, like, a little farmland with a little man-made lake right there. And that might maybe absorb all the water here.
Seek shelter immediately if
and then just to ensure that we keep water going to it, we can have, like, one little outflow pipe into it. Otherwise, yeah, our budget is like disaster. Like, I want to unlock the next milestone. So we're
Take
losing people.
And avoid roads and water
That's counterproductive.
Until the water recedes.
So yeah, let's survive. Let's come back from this, and let's just watch this last little meteor strike. Oh, neat! I can't even believe you said that. You know, what removes dead bodies. Great fire. I think you're. I don't say you're wrong.
A meteor
but...
strike has occurred. Avoid the impact site and head to shelter if any is available.
You got a lake now. Cool. As a bonus, you get a nice view of it from the train. Music's pretty fitting too. So So this can be something, like a little farmland with a little lake thing, and like a little deck or little dock, I mean. And then we probably need like a water outflow pipe just so that we can keep water in here. And I'm gonna keep it separate from our city just so we don't have to worry. So that means just for point of reference, this has to be like that, which is, I mean, a little bit silly, but just make sure I do that now. I know this looks so bad. Oh god, what have I done?
A tsunami has struck the city. Take caution and avoid roads and waterfronts until the water recedes.
In there. Oh, this thing needs power? Oh, for goodness sakes. A little water spilling into this, I love it. Now, my only fear is that like this might make too much water, so it might overflow. So we may have to make it a little bit bigger just to kind of suit the evaporation or something, I don't know. Or maybe that's like what we link the canal to, I don't know. This is, everything's just a work in progress. This is still pretty new mechanics and physics for me, so we'll see how she goes. And look, just dealing with our highway traffic, that's nice of them.
A tsunami has struck the city. Take caution and avoid roads and waterfronts until the water
recedes. To divert the river
over
here? That's just also not a bad idea. I can have like a small little outflow kind of sneak underneath things. Oh, do we have to fix our train tracks? Oh, we do. Neat. Now, how do I fix these, I wonder? Road upgrade tool? Nope. Well, darn it, how do I fix these? I think I have to delete them, probably, and put them back in? But I guess we have to wait for the water to stop first. See, I feel like this could be never-ending just because of this thing, right? Curtilicious, not per se, but I can kind of talk a little bit about districts. I don't really normally do too many districts or policies until a city's about more or less this kind of size anyhow. But some things that I'll kind of encourage would be, say, let me just make a small district just for funsies. I would do, you know, like biking, like that kind of stuff. So I would do encourage biking. I would probably put in some lightning rods, which would help with our storms if you wanted fast recovery for this. But as far as like in-town stuff goes, if you have like a residential neighborhood, I'd probably do a focus on parks and recreation, do like an education boost, recycling. A lot of the other things are pretty expensive. And then I'd probably also do, if this is like a residential neighborhood, probably do like a high-rise ban if you want to keep it just like small houses. And you can do not in my backyard, and that would help with noisy vehicles and that kind of stuff. Same with traffic ban and everything, so. But in my little vanilla tutorial series, the new one I'm working on, I'll be doing policies and districts pretty soon with that, so not too long from now I'll have a video. Is the short or the long for that? Oh, and leisures, like a specialized zone. Those ones I would do, like a leisure zone is fine for like tourists and your people and stuff. And those aren't overly noisy. It's just like if you're doing a nightlife one, that one's noisy. But those are good to have too, because they help with the nighttime budget. Because if you're playing with the day-night cycle, you might notice that at night your budget goes into the negatives. But yeah, I'll do an episode on that. I'll kind of cover as much as I can, type thing. And I wonder if we can just go over that. No. Dude, to me it looked like that was broken before. I guess it's just the interchange, though. And I still am inconclusive about this, whether or not we should keep that or whatever. Or if we needed to, like, connect to another, like, a bigger water source or whatever. Because water evaporates, so if we give larger surface area, theoretically more can evaporate, so if we expand on this lake here. You know what we could have done is fire down another meteor or two, just to make that a more natural... take a more natural approach. Let's just see if this overflows, though. Is all the DLC worth it? I personally think it is. If you're patient, you can get all of it pretty much on sale. But it depends on what you're after. Like, if you really like trams, then the Snowfall DLC is totally worth it just for like that alone. And if you're a fan of just blowing stuff up, then definitely the Natural Disasters is for you. And then, you know, for me, like the extra transit buildings, like the bigger bus shelter, like that kind of stuff, it was worth it to get the After Dark. And then, yeah, often when they're on sale, I think most of them are like $7 or less type thing, so... killer value, especially if you play the game often. And Disasters, I've been playing like consistently for about a week straight now, and I haven't kind of hit that point where I'm like tired of blowing stuff up. It's kind of, and even then, you're not really buying the Disasters mods solely for Disasters. You're getting like new fire mechanics, new buildings, new way of like dealing with, you know, like just fire and like helicopters, right? Like stuff like that, you know? So those things are keeping me busy. Okay, slowly getting everything back in order here. Yeah, wait for the Christmas sales. I think they announced on Steam that the sale is going to be the 22nd. You guys can correct me if I'm wrong about that, but I think that sounds right to me. Alright, it's coming back here. The comeback kid. Our budget, though, is the only thing that I'm kind of worried about. We started the stream with like 4 million credits, and now we're like, you know, we ain't doing too well here. The only reason you bought it was because of the meteor? Well, I can't say I blame you. It's actually one of the fun ones to definitely use. That's cool, right? Oh, how's this doing? Oh, good. Self-sustaining. Guys, our lake works. That's it. We'll leave it just like that. Perfect. Nice, nice, nice. So yeah, this little area here, this can be farmland. Awesome. All right, let's try and get our areas cleaned up a little bit more. Let's kind of, I guess, deal a little bit more with the death care. Like, why are these buildings not operating, I wonder? Curses of me is zero. It's almost like they're not connected. See how it's not turning purple? I wonder what the logic would be for that. Maybe if we delete it and put a new one in? I know, unfortunately, there's still a couple bugs that have made their way through in terms of mechanics, so this could be one of them. I don't quite have an answer as to why this would be happening. I need to pick a new spot altogether. Switch that back over to some office space here. Crater pool? Yeah, I wish you could make some pools, actually. Gotta fill in some classical music again here. Get back into the zone of building. See, this one too, same idea. It's not switching on. Looks like that one, same thing. I wonder what the secret is to this. Alright, well maybe time is the factor. But we seem to be having issues with garbage being picked up. I think we have okay coverage. Yeah, see this building over here also isn't turned on. Whereas like those ones are kind of highlighted in the purple. What does it all mean? I don't know. Yeah, I know. I'm about to go broke. I know. Half our money, since I last pointed out, is already gone, too. Well, the real thing would be just to kind of stimulate our RCI demand again. And so I'm kind of hoping that a lot of our buildings will kind of rebuild on their own. But we can just, you know, put some people in. Let's find a zone for some high density. So before we go broke, let's put some of our money here to use. It's not too steep, luckily. Repurposing some of these areas here. I just have it paused just so that we don't lose any more money right now. I think I'm going to do a mix over here of high and low density, but I'm going to focus mainly on high density just to get the most amount of people in here. There we go, just a little bit of each. Okay, we're schooling. There's one more down here. Okay, 3-speed. Let's do it. Let's be optimistic here, guys. Maybe this can be residential, too. I don't think we're in, like, the biggest world of trouble. I think we can still come back from this. I'm fairly confident. I think most of the cost came from having to deal with disaster response, too. And what in the heck's going on here? I guess that's a tsunami finally figuring itself out. So when the disaster response teams have, like, stopped searching all the buildings and everything, like, that'll be a lot of our budget kind of going back to normal. And, of course, if we do get more people in here, that'll help with the budget and everything, too. Turn off evacuation. Oh my gosh, guys, I love you. Thank you so much. Thank you, all of you. Yes.
Experts predict an earthquake could hit the area soon.
No! Why? Finally, our first random disaster. Thank you, guys. Turn off chat. Well, at least the mystery's been solved. That's good news, right? But we have an earthquake coming, so we had to send everyone back to the disaster shelters. Well, thanks, guys. I guess we figured that out. I'm still a noob. All right, so I guess we'll wait patiently and see where the earthquake will hit. This is kind of, like, scary. I know, we're talking about timing too, right? Just when we thought we had everything under control. And guys, I'm so sorry. I don't mean to ignore the chat. I just, you know, I get sometimes a little bit focused and my stubbornness sometimes, you know? Aneurysm. I'm so sorry. I don't mean to ignore you guys. I know you're just breaking your keyboards and stuff. I'm sorry. If I could afford to buy you all new keyboards now, I would. Oh, the waiting game is the worst part about all this. I just don't know where it's going to strike, right? Is that the epicenter right there? Oh, no. That's like the beautiful part of the town. No. Why does it have to happen to us? Oh, man. That sucks.
An earthquake is occurring.
Oh, really?
Don't panic and wait for help if you are in the affected area.
Why does this have to happen? Oh, look at the fault line too. This is so cool. That's a lot to fix though. That's really bad. Because, you know, the worst part is it has to happen right on the interchange. Can't happen anywhere else, right? Hmm. Unshaking? Okay. Well, we might have just enough money to fix all this. I also, maybe I'm gonna have to, I think we can still do it. Okay. Okie dokie. I'm confident here. The best is like the background elevator music. I gotta remember not to forget to turn. Actually, let's do this right now. But I'm gonna keep it paused just because our budget. Like, I just need this money for what we're doing right now. Is that how that one looks? Yeah, kinda. Oh no! Alright, let me do some terraforming here. I'm trying to avoid this because we have too much soil. Oh darn it. Oh, can we finally do some more? Yeah, we can. This is just temporary, because I don't know where else to put this right now. Probably enough to fill this in. Man, we wanted a challenge, and here it is. Our poor city, I know, right? Okay, so that's that reconnected. Let's get these directions going the right way. And did we need this to be tram? We did indeed, so I used the wrong road earlier. My mistake. Repair that. Okay. There we go. That's that side reconnected. I imagine this probably just went and curved in the way it kind of follows. Oh, that probably went like that. Okay. I gotcha. And our poor piping, like everything is destroyed. Oh my goodness, this is ridiculous. So dramatic. What would happen if a power plant hits the nuclear power plant? I think it just destroys it. I don't think they have like nuclear explosions or anything like that in this game. But that would be like insane. Can you imagine if you had like an explosion similar to like what the meteor looked like just happening? I'd be like, oh my gosh. All right, so Cloverleaf back in shape. And everything's connected properly. I think all of our roads over here have been new. They have not been repaired, not even close. Almost. Wishful thinking. You know what it is? It's the music. That's what's keeping me so upbeat and cheery during all this. Well, gosh darn it, I think we've gone ahead and done it. Look at that. Of course, everything's still on fire and whatnot, but like, I mean, the roads are kind of back in. All right, I think we're doing okay. Relatively. Oh man, what a doozy it did to our pipes here. Are we like not connected over here? Is that what's happening? Yeah. Fascinating. It like severed the link between where our water pipe is. You can see this half has water, whereas this half has sewage, which is why the color is different. That's really interesting. Okay, so that's that. I'm gonna put 3 speed back on now. I think we're safe. Perfect time with the music too. Okay. I'm hoping that our transit routes will kind of figure their pathways and stuff back out. Oh, phew. Yeah, we've basically hit the city with almost every single disaster we had at our arsenal, I think, so far. We didn't do a sinkhole. Still a few fires burning. Oh my gosh. But look, our budgets. Hey, all I gotta do is put people back to work and they make money for you. How about that, huh? Just like on the television. That's probably why nothing was working, because no one was at work, right? Yeah, so that's running. That one running again too? Yeah, look at that. So that means these buildings are probably up and running again too. Yes. Ooh, very good. Cool. Let's rebuild a few more of our essential buildings over here, but I think we're starting to get back on track financially and just, you know, visually and everything like that. Sinkholes? Oh gosh. Mr. Lionsbane, my friend, I will see you later. Oh, and we have to. Are you free tonight? Like, for some chatting, my friend? Because I have some developments I need to share with you. We can chat on the old Discord or something. Or I'll give you a shout on what is that thing called? Twitter. But yeah, I'll show you guys a sinkhole. Just kind of speaking of them, but I mean they frustrate me because they're inconvenient. I'm gonna put one just over here, so it's in the middle of nowhere. But it's just exactly what you think it would be, just like a giant hole, just the ground gives away type thing. Just making sure none of these are like essential city service buildings that need to be replaced. But I think not. Anyway, the camera will pull us over here when that is ready to go. But yeah, I think we're back on track here. That's actually a pretty crazy recovery. So we had a tornado, two
earthquakes. Geologists predict that a sinkhole could strike at any minute.
Multiple forest fires.
Residents should take precautionary measures.
Speaking of which,
the Forest Service has stated that there is a risk of an imminent forest fire in the area. Residents are advised to avoid forested areas.
Okay, I'll send you a Twitter, man.
A sinkhole has occurred somewhere in the city. Stay out of harm's way and contact authorities with any information.
It's like, this is super inconvenient. That happens like one of your major
leave campsites and tree houses immediately.
And when you have trees like really close together, oh my goodness, the horrifying disaster that is a forest fire. Because fire now spreads from building to building. So, like, I'm so determined to get this entire area to burn down. I don't know what it is.
The Forest Service has stated that there is a risk of an imminent forest fire in the area. Residents are advised to avoid forested areas.
So, if you have, like, a lot of trees in your city,
if this happens,
like, oh my gosh.
Leave campsites and tree houses immediately.
No, we're not. No, Greg, we're not condemning the city. Last week, we did that. Last week, we condemned the city, and we blew it to, like, absolute smithereens. If you guys want, I mean, like, I'm not opposed to just, I'll save the game type thing, and in the last, like, 5 minutes of the stream, we can just blow this place, like, just to Kingdom Come type thing, if you guys want to do that. And then I wouldn't save it, because that was pretty challenging to come back from.
A forest fire is raging in the area.
And that these actually, campsites and that was almost the end of the city, just in general. I mean, see how crazy this is, though. Like, the fire spreads really quickly, it goes from, like, building to building. So if you don't have, like, a pretty good disaster response team
in place. A forest fire is raging in the area. Leave campsites and treehouses immediately.
I can't consciously do that. Just make a city without fire stations and just... That's too anarchy for me. Even just doing this makes me, like, unhappy, you know? I like when things are calm and not on fire. Call me old-fashioned, I guess. But then at the same time, I'm like having way too much fun just starting fires. Like, I really think I'm like a pyromaniac. I just didn't know
it. The Forest Service has stated that there is
this
a risk
is bringing
of
out
imminent
the,
forest fire
the, you know,
in the area.
Worst in me or something.
Residents
I don't know.
Residents are advised to avoid forested areas. A forest fire is
no,
raging
me Thunder. I didn't say
area.
It before. This was just
leave
us.
Leave campsites and treehouses.
Yeah, we were just going for it. So if we couldn't save the city, that would have been it. We would have to start a new city in the next
a
stream.
A forest fire is raging in the area. Leave campsites and treehouses immediately.
Taking a little bit of a gamble, I guess. All right, I think we're good here. So this is still going strong, which is great. It's our little man-made lake here. That'll soon have a little farm. I did want to try. Oh my gosh, I did want to try doing a waterfall
in the area. Leave campsites and tree houses immediately.
And we get that at 48,000 people. So let's try and get another tile unlocked, because I would love to purchase. I have such a conflict right now. We should be buying this one over here, just so we can work on our transport hub. But I want to buy this one so I can make this elaborate waterfall system going down towards the coast.
A forest fire is raging in the area. Leave sites and tree houses immediately.
I think the waterfall sounds a little bit more fun. So why don't we do some more residential zoning? Just get some people living in here type thing. And I think we should have another avenue or something kind of come through.
A forest fire is raging in the area. Leave campsites and tree houses immediately.
Not sure where this is going to end up. Just kind of like a weird support road. This is going to kind of intersect a few neighborhoods. I'm just looking to do some just fast zoning right now. And I also just don't want to be too far away from an avenue just in general. So we're just going to have one kind of sneak its way through. These are my temporary locations for those guys, so we'll just move them again. And when we end up with some more space after we unlock, say, like two or three more tiles, I want to just create like a small like island or just some area where all like one of each type of emergency response type thing can kind of hang out. And we can move our disaster response unit, like the whole team over there. Those to line up, that'd be so cool. I don't think it's gonna happen though. Is that even going straight relative to the rest of the city? I can't tell all these hills. This is challenging. Alright, well whatever, let's just leave that. Oh goodness, that was such a, well, I mean it turned out well, but oh my gosh. Sometimes when I get stubborn. Like now, for example. There's just so many things I wish were easier to do in the game. And like when I start some of these projects, like in my mind, like this will just take 5 or 10 minutes. We'll just quickly do it. And it's like an hour later, I'm like, I am so sorry. Why are we still working on this? It's not looking too bad. Kind of incorporates a little bit of a curviness into our neighborhood building. Maybe we can even have one more that just kind of sneaks through.
Here's one. Do you ever play any music?
Just adds a little bit more variety to how the buildings kind of come in.
Listen, I don't think so. See, I find it's much.
Okay, let's zone, because I want people. I want a new milestone.
Rather than the manufacturing process or the equipment on which drums are made.
And if you guys haven't yet, I highly, highly, highly recommend listening to like the small talk banter, like slash commercials or whatever the DJ hosts are doing. Like it's like Colossal Order just went above and beyond, I think, for this DLC. This is honestly, in my opinion, one of the best ones they've done. Like for production value, they put a lot of effort into it, which is probably why it's a little bit more expensive than the other ones. But I'm a big fan of it. And honestly, I like Colossal Order, I like Paradox, I think as a company they have good business practices, so I don't mind supporting them, because obviously it keeps this game relevant and fresh and everything. Is underwater DLC? No, I wish there was some. It'd be kind of cool if you could do like submarines and like boating and everything, but you get tsunamis in this, so it's a little bit of water experience, but. But if you don't want any disasters, guys, you can always turn them off. Like, I've got the frequency up just past the halfway point. You can click them on or off if you want, type thing. And obviously, if you want, you can just use it manually, just the way we've been kind of doing that. But you can buy the Disasters DLC and then never use the Disasters and just kind of take advantage of the other stuff that comes with it, like the new fire mechanics and everything, right? And traffic, my goodness, it's getting so backed up over here. This, to me, is very inefficient, so let's get rid of that. We're gonna need a another bridge or a tunnel or something, kind of like what we had before. I'm actually going to get rid of that. That's too slow. Make people go, yeah, that way. That makes that not that efficient anymore, though. Because you gotta... Oh, boy. What a mess we're making here. One second, guys. I'm going to have the highway off-ramp just end in a more, like, practical place. It might go underground and pop up around here type thing, which is gonna be a little odd, but I just need some function that's a bit more Try having a light govern things here just really quickly and see if that makes a difference before I get too carried away with everything else. I'm going to just try to have a little bit more room for everyone to kind of back up to. Traffic kind of queue a little bit further without affecting our highway. See if that makes a difference. It's going to be, you know, the timing of light is going to be the biggest factor here. And then to help with that, we can have this last little stretch here become two lane. Yeah, that's what I was worried about. See, I have to wait for two lights now? That's silly. So I guess we're going back to this. And then, it's like I would love to have a traffic light here somehow. Yeah, even that, just so we have, there we go. I know that's a little bit strange. I just want a little bit of governance to this intersection though. And then we need now another access to go over the highway to free up some of that. Is there an arc in case of tsunami? Oh, that'd be kind of funny actually, if you had a big city boat you can all go into. No, nothing like that. You just kind of go into emergency disaster shelters. But I like your thinking. Well, I guess we missed a few roads over here in terms of repairs.
Warning. Experts predict an earthquake could hit the area soon.
Oh my gosh, no! You stop with the earthquakes, please! Oh boy, just when you thought everything was fine and dandy, right? Alright, well, we know exactly where it's going to hit, too. We have, like, one massive epicenter always. I'm just going to move this down slightly, give us a bit more room for our trams and this road to kind of come in. Well, this game, if nothing else, has a really good sense of humor. That's good, at least, right? And we're just on pause, just until I kind of figure this out. And then we'll let the disaster strike, and then we'll try and make another comeback. Comeback kid. We can do it, though. Oh, actually, no, that's perfect. That's right there. So what I was hoping for with this, I'm going to change the slope a little bit here. Change that too. Is I want, you can see what I was doing that, is to have this above ground. That go like this. This break into two. (Clears throat) Yeah, that's cool. And that way you get a little bit of use out of those, you know, one-way streets. Now the irony would be if I just finished building this and then the earthquake takes it out. I could see that as something that would happen to us. At least the game is nice, peaceful music as it destroys and breaks our heart. Okay, great. So that's our little supplement road to kind of help with everything. And that's just to alleviate traffic on this little bridge, hopefully. And I imagine... Does this show where our disaster risk is? Oh, look at this! Beautiful! Wonderful! We are ever fortunate, guys. All we have to lose is our highway. We get a fancy new fault line, too.
Don't panic, and wait for help if you are in the affected area.
Yeah, Billy, you've been here since the beginning, man. I love that. Yeah, honestly, my chat, like, you know, it just kind of comes and goes. But, like, my feelings aren't hurt if we don't have an active chat. Oh, you know what we could do is use this as an excuse to kind of start a way to make this back over to the river, which I think was a suggestion we had come in a long time ago, too. Oh, looks like we lost some pipes again. Alright, tell us your secrets. Where did that pipe just break? That one's broken. See, it's like here, why did the... Are we just out of sewage treatment? Do we need more of it? Are these not enough anymore? Plausible. I forgot we can't go across the those canals. Alright, well, that should help, but I still don't understand why we're not getting full. Maybe we're just kind of low on that in general. Well, that was probably just it. Okay, yeah, let's try just doing a little bit of terraforming and just getting, yeah, why not, right? Just the smallest little river kind of through here. And then we'll build up that kind of mountainy thing and we can have like a little waterfall here. And finally build my waterfall mountain. So happy. I'm trying not to go too over the farmland. Let's have like a little waterfall or something, right? And we'll just bridge over with all that stuff. So we'll just delete these for the moment. We can get lucky, we can get like a double waterfall kind of action happening over here. And like, you know, be really cool is if we have some like little obstacles, so the water kind of gets kind of like, you know, like a bubbly effect, but like not really, because it's kind of hard to do that in this game. But I wanted to make it seem like, yeah, there's like rapids and like waterfall kind of feel. Why don't we mix this all up? And too much terrain again, no problem. So not too much more over there. Instead, I'm probably just gonna, yeah, we'll fill in these like these spots. And there we go, a lot of terrain use, perfect. Making a river, well, I mean, you know, what river waterfall, we're just kind of going the whole way with this, it looks like. Let's make just a bit of a deeper channel just to ensure that we get a lot of water kind of going through here. I don't want to go uphill, silly. I want to go downhill with that. There we go. Just to ensure that the bulk of the current just moves downhill. Smooth that out. Alright, neat. Now we can bridge, and I'm going to have another outflow pipe, so that should be enough water to kind of keep this going. And I think just to ensure that we don't spill over the edges, I'm just gonna maybe build that up slightly. Nice. Very, very nice. All right, Billy, thanks for stopping by, man. Great having you here. Hope to see you again. Oops, that was supposed to be a bridge. Apparently the train didn't get the memo. No. What is going on here? I think the water is maybe having a bit of an effect on... You can kind of see it's like making weird pillar heights there. I may have to let the water settle and then put the bridge in afterwards. Or just maybe go a bit taller to start. Yeah, that's better. There we go. And we can probably make this a smoother transition. Yeah, I probably won't be streaming too much longer today. And I don't know what day I'm going to midweek, but I'll definitely be doing a midweek stream. And then just in general, we always do a Skyline stream Sundays, 2 p.m. So be there, be square type thing. So worst case, you can always, you know, check back next week and I'll see you then type thing. There we go, that's that connected. That should look really nice when we get water going through there. And onto our highway friends here. Nope, not doing that. Let's try and get those even.
Thanks for listening to the classics. Your home for the best works.
We should be a bit higher on that side. Yeah, I guess we're gonna do a little bridge like that. Why not? I like this song. Don't think that's going straight, unfortunately. Getting this to like be the same is going to be such a challenge. I'm sure there's a easy way to kind of do it. Let's see if we can just kind of wing this. Looks like that's the right height. I think if I just go kind of where the same pillars are, that we can end up with the same style of... Yeah, oh yeah. Oh, delicious. It's like we're planning this or something. Look at that. Magnifique. A little bit crooked. That's really strangely crooked. Side not as bad. I'm like, what is going on with this one, right? It's like almost comedic. That's much better. Alright. We are going places, my friends. We are definitely going places. I feel like if we go any further back, I won't be like at the pillar to line up there. So I'll just leave that. Alright, last on the list right here. Oh, Greg, yeah, I was, like, basically right now, I'm just not really using any mods. And, like, my reason for that is when I found out about the Natural Disasters DLC a few weeks ago, I just kind of knew that when it would finally be released, that, like, all the mods would have an issue. And it just, you know, it's frustrating when you can't play your city, especially when you're like eager to work on it. So I just kind of prepared for that ahead of time and just kind of switched everything over to like a vanilla style series. So I'll definitely be going back into mods. Like, I know most of them are already fixed, so it won't be too long from now, but I've also had just a lot of requests in general for some like non-modded just kind of material, like tutorial stuff and this and that. So just kind of, you know, taking a break in from mods in that sense, but there are definitely some fantastic ones that I'm really missing. I know that Network Extension just got some new roads too, like the irregular ones. You know, like three in one roads and three in twos, like three lanes on one side, you know, that kind of thing, two on the other. Oh, that's beautiful. Minus that spot. You silly bit of track, what's going on over here? Much better. The mods that stopped working off the top of my head, I can't quite think, but it was literally like three quarters of mods. Like, I tried running the game with mods, I couldn't even get the game to start. Do we need power on this? I guess we do. I know most of them have been fixed. I know the Bloody Penguin, he's a mod creator who makes most of the mods, has been pretty active on the City Skylines subreddit, kind of keeping people up to date. And he's the one that did like Surface Painter and like the 81 tiles and like all that stuff. But just most of the things just weren't compatible. But I mean, that's totally no surprise. Like every time there's a big mod, you know, that gets released, like, or a DLC that gets released, that's what happens. So there we go. Cool. I think we're back in order. Yes, look at this. Water. I love it. Alright, let's build a waterfall. Hopefully. There's some staggered points where it'll fall down. Oops, I'm gonna be down, silly. Let me see what this would look like, just out of curiosity. See if we can kind of build as this falls. It's like, this I find is fascinating. It's like, how is it working if it's asking for power? Make up your mind, child. What do you need here? If you're making Romania, you have to include holes in the road. Oh my goodness. Yeah, it's so funny. Like, I'll complain about the potholes in like Toronto and stuff, and then I'll see like just like other people's cities and stuff, and I'm like, oh my gosh. We have it pretty good over here. I wouldn't say this is like the craziest of waterfalls, but it's kind of a waterfall. What happens if we decorate it a bit? Rocks will affect the flow of the water too. So we get maybe some splashies off some of these. I also just like the look of rocks in general. Sort of, kind of, right? But not quite. That's a bit better. No, this is just regular water, actually. With the new DLC, you get a freshwater outflow pipe. And so this is supposedly supposed to help you with your flooding. Same with this building here. We actually haven't put one of these down. So, pumping service building. This guy here is going to go through, and we still have a lot of problems with sewage, looks like. I guess these are still not functioning properly. Anyway, these trucks will be dispatched and they'll kind of clean up the flooding in your city. And you also have new reservoir tanks So that in case, oh yeah, I guess we don't have sewage being treated properly. So in case like you lose power or whatever and you need like, you know, your water pump stop working, if you have these things connected and full of water, they're kind of like a little temporary stopgap just to kind of make sure that you got some water for the short run. And it might help maybe if we bring some power over here. I think that's probably what the issue is. That should help with that. Perfect. So I do want to get these out of the river, and I want this to be elsewhere. I don't want to keep filling our area up here with sewage. Same with the canals. I don't want that full of sewage too, you know? Yeah, I know what you mean, Valentine. I don't know why that would need power either. If it's just water being forced out by gravity or something. But, I mean, look at that. We have a little waterfall. That's kind of cool. These giant rocks, though, like this, they trap too much water. Like, I wish water flowed a little bit more naturally over those things. A little bit better. So we can make some more things like this. This is just kind of like a little proof of concept right here. There we go. Maybe there's a little rock in the center. These are the kind of things that's like so hard to say that you're done, you know? Like, how do you know when you're really finished? That's kind of cool, though. We build a dam? Oh, totally. That's a cool idea. I was actually talking about making a dam in through here. Doesn't create that much electricity, though. I guess I could see possibly working. We can get the kind of angle and everything right. Logically, it's probably the best spot too for one. I'm trying to get it so that little box thing lines up just in the center of the river, so just visually it looks pretty nice. Yeah, just like that. Now, this worries me that it's going to back up. I don't know if we're going to have to put in any floodgates or anything like that. I think we should be okay with just the spill through on the dam itself. But you never know when it comes to this. And then the dam generates electricity, just in the game at least, based on the difference between the height and the two water levels. So this should be a really decent producer once this kind of settles and the water down here kind of finishes doing its own thing. Is this a boat that's down here that's been lost? Oh, it's one of those, it's one of those things. Like the, what am I trying to say? Like the little props or whatever you can just randomly drop. I guess someone dropped one of those when they were creating the map and they got lost to the terraforming or something. Maybe we can just connect over to here. Just temporary. Gotta figure out how we're gonna get that tram over there, but gotta buy some more city tiles first. And this poor area over here, just there's not a lot of demand right now, so these factory buildings aren't gonna be rebuilt until that kinda, you know, sorts itself out. It probably would. Oh, actually, shoot, I just realized these are now up here. Well, whatever. You could artificially create your own area for a dam by using the water outflow pipes and doing something kind of like this, where we'd have, like, you know, the dam kind of be down here. And I think I'm going to make this a little bit steeper, just so we get more water flow kind of through here. I kind of thought this would be, like, you know, a lot more just like gushing water kind of feeling. Hey, cool, Colossal City. Awesome, that's kind of what it's after. I did want to buy this so that we could do essentially that over on this side, but what is it until we reach the next milestone? 70,000, that's for the airports, right? Because we need, I think, to purchase, yeah, both of these to fix our airport area. So I gotta be responsible and buy those, but I think we'll wait till we unlock the next one just to be double sure here. How do you clean up polluted water? You kind of can't, unfortunately. What I think I'm going to end up doing is maybe making our own little, like, kind of deep reservoir basin thing and just have all the sewage water go there, and then just it'll evaporate a bit, so we can kind of just leave it like that. So unfortunately, we're creating like a sewage kind of like dam thing here, so these have to go downward now. But this is just temporary, because I don't really like the way this is kind of unfolding. So what I want, yeah, it's just like a little area just for utilities with some canals and like a whole bunch of other stuff, just to kind of make the area feel like it has a bit more purpose and whatnot. There we go. So that stops these things from absorbing the poop water. Hopefully. And is this producing any power? It should be now. What? Oh, darn it. It's not. Well, I guess this has to settle some more. Maybe that'll just let that run. Either way, I'm still happy we have a dam here. Looks kind of cool. And I think you guys know what I'm thinking. I think it might be time for us to try out some more disasters. If you don't destroy and replace the abandoned buildings, it doesn't really do anything but kind of lower the land value a little bit. And these buildings here are more susceptible to like fire and stuff. So there's, you know, a little bit of a negative downside. I just happen to be a bit lazy, so I don't necessarily want to go through the entire city and just delete all the buildings that need to be. But that's just kind of me. But no, you probably should, you know, take care of them. But if we get demand kind of moving back up, that'll kind of do that for us. Because we actually had like whole zones that were like still, yeah, that looked all just like this. Earlier in the stream, we had quite a few disasters go through and just everything kind of fell apart. Anyway, so what I want to do now, guys, is I'm going to give this a save and make that stream 4. Perfect. And I want to, just blow up the whole city here because, you know, it's saved now. I don't have to worry. And I think we're probably going to end things off after the total destruction. So just for you guys who've been patiently sitting here wanting to see more massive destruction on a larger scale, we can just start blowing
the
city up.
The Forest Service has stated that there is a risk of an imminent forest fire in the area. Residents are advised to avoid forested areas. The Forest
and the
Service
camera,
has stated
it's
gonna
that pull
there is
me
a
around
risk of
wherever
an
the newest disaster is
the
kind
area.
Of striking. So
residents are advised to avoid forested areas. A forest fire is raging in the area. Leave campsites and treehouses immediately. The Forest Service has stated that there is a risk of an imminent forest fire in the area.
Let's turn on our day-night cycles, too. This is going to be just, like, absolutely insane. Just, like, 5 minutes of just continuous disasters.
Yeah. Residents are advised to avoid forested areas.
Oh, my gosh.
A forest fire is raging in the area. Leave campsites and treehouses immediately.
Astrologists report that a devastating meteor will strike the city in the near future. Residents should seek shelter immediately if any is available.
Meteorologists are issuing a thunderstorm warning for the coming days. Citizens are advised to stay indoors. The Forest Service has stated that there is a risk of an imminent forest fire in the area. Residents are advised to avoid forested areas.
A forest fire is raging in the area.
Oh, Hugh Jordan, thanks for saying such nice things, man.
Meteorologists have issued a severe tornado warning for the area. Residents should seek shelter immediately if any is available.
And I got some more City Skylines content to be posting either tonight or tomorrow for you guys.
Residents should seek shelter immediately if any is available.
And I'll be posting the stream to the YouTube channel too.
Experts predict an earthquake could hit the area soon.
How do you turn the day on? Oh, there's day-night cycles. You can just, in your options menu under gameplay, you can turn on your day-night cycles, you can use dynamic weather, you can turn on or off your disasters if you have the DLC, and you can turn up or down the frequency. And then when you're playing at night, your mouse by default is going to have a big flashlight on it, so you can kind of see to a certain extent what you're building. And holy heck, that is a massive meteor strike.
A meteor strike has occurred. Avoid the impact site and head to shelter if any is available.
Look at that fire.
A forest fire is raging in the area. Leave campsites and treehouses immediately.
Oh my gosh, that meteor.
A thunderstorm is battering the city.
What?
Stay indoors until the storm has passed. A forest fire is raging in the area.
Holy smokes.
Leave campsites and treehouses immediately. A tornado has touched down in the area.
Oh,
seek shelter
too.
Immediately if any is available.
Here
a meteor strike has occurred. Avoid the impact site.
Here comes
and
the fault line
to
too. You can see it opening.
Available.
Oh, that's so cool.
An earthquake is occurring. Don't panic and wait for help if you are in the affected area.
Oh man, this is too much. This is absolutely insane. Hey, Curtilicious, what's going on? So we are, unfortunately, for all those of you who are just jumping in, we are kind of wrapping things up. I've been streaming for almost 3 hours. I was actually only planning on streaming for 2 hours or so today, but we had way too much fun, which is kind of the case. I do plan on doing a midweek stream. I don't necessarily know what day it's going to be. Probably like, you know, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, one of those kind of things. And it'll be in the evening, and I'm over in Eastern time zone, so if that kind of helps you guys. And I will be uploading this stream to the YouTube channel, and I'm just going to kind of go back to doing some more recording after this, and I'll be uploading hopefully something either tonight or tomorrow for you guys to watch. But otherwise, we do a weekly City Skylines stream, so 2 p.m. Sundays, and that's 2 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. Totally come check us out again, guys. We'd love to have you hang out. A lot of you are new today, and I really appreciate that. You want sax song? Oh, yeah, let's do it. Let's absolutely do it. You're absolutely right. We haven't even heard that yet this stream. Yeah, let's get that going. And let me get my music all set up here. I think that's about right. Oh, a little bit too fast. There we go. All right, it's a song after this one, so we'll kind of let it build in. And oh my gosh, my poor computer is like, what is happening here? It's like, a lot happening. Yeah, I saved it just before all the destruction went into.
Meteorologists are issuing a thunderstorm warning for the coming days. Citizens are advised to stay indoors. A forest fire is raging in the area. Leave campsites and treehouses immediately.
I personally think that the meteors have the most impact because it starts a massive fire, it
a
creates like an earthquake,
in
it
the
creates
area.
A tsunami as well.
Immediately if any is available.
Yeah, Paradox Interactive makes this game, and Colossal Order is Colossal Order is the actual company that makes it. Paradox owns them. All right, guys, this song here, it's like the unofficial song of the stream. We call it the sax song, or the sax song. So sit back, enjoy. And I usually switch it over to emote only, so blast some emotes, guys. Yeah, blast some emotes, have a good time. Let me just drop down some more disasters, but we'll just destroy the city, and that'll be kind of how we'll wrap up for today.
Meteorologists are issuing a thunderstorm warning for the coming days. Citizens are advised to stay indoors. The Forest Service has stated that there is a risk of an imminent forest fire in the area. Residents are advised to
yes. Get those emotes going, guys.
Meteorologists have issued a severe tornado warning for the area. Residents should seek shelter immediately if any is available.
Yes, excellent. Not only that, I love this song. It's so good to listen to.
Meteorologists are issuing a thunderstorm warning for the coming days. Citizens are advised to stay indoors. A forest fire is raging in the area.
Oh my gosh,
this
poor city.
Leave campsites and treehouses
immediately. And what's cool is like the roads and everything that are damaged.
The
transport hub.
Residents should seek shelter immediately.
But yeah, like the roads that are damaged, like the lights and everything, like the traffic lights don't work. And like same with the regular street lamps.
Avoid the impact site and head to shelter if any is available. A tornado has touched down in the area. Seek shelter immediately if any is available.
Guys, I love you all. This is like the best emote wall we've seen ever. We're all very beautiful people. I love it. Keep it up, guys. This is so great. I love the song. Get the goosebumps every time. I don't want to be the only one dancing here. Terrible, terrible. I love that song. All right, you guys are free to chat again. Well, I think we're gonna wrap things up, guys. So thanks for hanging out. Our poor city is in shambles. Let's turn up the house lights here and see what it looks like. It's always fun though, blowing stuff up at the end of the stream. Oh my gosh, did we ever do a number?
Of a tsunami approaching
the
area.
And of course the tsunami. Forgot all about it.
And waterfronts.
Oh, sax song. Let me just put that in right there. There's the link to it right there, guys. And if you want just like a really, really, really awesome playlist, this is what I use a lot of the time for when I'm streaming. It's about 2 hours long. Or it's only an hour long or so. Anyway, guys, we are wrapping up, but every Sunday at 2 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, we do the City Skyline stream. We've been working on this city for, I guess, 4 or 5 weeks now. We'll continue with this in the next stream. I did save it before I dropped down all of these disasters, but a lot of work is left to do with this, so don't let this stuff scare you. There still is a city kind of hidden in here. And I do plan on doing a stream midweek. I'll most likely be playing a game like different than City Skylines, probably some Rust, maybe some like Transport Fever or something like that. So
a tornado has touched down in the area.
And for those of you that are just kind of jumping in now and did kind of want to watch the stream, I will be uploading this to my YouTube channel and probably have that up either tonight or tomorrow. And I'm trying to get a video out just in general for tonight or tomorrow too. And we don't have, unfortunately, a community Discord yet. Those kind of things I'm totally working on. I want to get a few community game servers together just so we can kind of start all of us hanging out a little more often. But, you know, slowly but surely, we'll get all this together. Otherwise, I think that's it, guys. So, thanks for hanging out. I will see you again. All the best.
You beautiful, beautiful people.
What's the song name? It's called Everybody by K391. That was that sax song that we were listening to. And there's a clicky link. Just type in, if you do !! sax song, Nightbot will tell you what it is. One of our little mod things right there. Perfect. Alright guys, well I'll see you again. Follow me on Twitter for some updates on when I'm streaming next, and yeah, you're all wonderful. So thanks guys. Thanks for hanging out with me. See you again. Take care of yourselves.